Valley, Florida. Number 91, Seth Weller. At defensive tackle, sophomore from Georgetown. Number 90, Anthony Blair. The linebacker, a junior from Swansea, South Carolina. Number 41, Randy Brown. That linebacker, senior from Easley. Number 53, Sam
And welcome
Houston.
Into Yount Stadium here on that the campus of North Greenville University. Ready for some Thursday night football here on the North Greenville Sports Network as North Greenville gets ready to take on the Citadel Bulldogs from Charleston, South Carolina. Grace Sullivan alongside Dave Parson with Ansley Brock down on the sidelines to bring you tonight's game as Citadel makes a trip up I-26 because out of circumstances due to circumstances beyond our control, Hurricane Matthew working its way up the East Coast, expected to hit or at the coast of South Carolina, Charleston area Friday night into Saturday. Governor Nikki Haley ordering mandatory evacuations of the coast, several games being canceled or moved. This is one of them. The Citadel will keep their home team status, and it looks like they're going to come out in the all-gray uniforms, which is their duty uniforms. Dave, they look quite spiffy in those.
Yeah, they do. Welcome, Gray. Welcome, everybody, to the North Greenville Sports Network. It is Thursday, October the 6th, 2015. We're glad you're with us. The Citadel is coming up here. It was a good call by both teams, both universities, to go ahead and play this game on a Thursday night and not wait until the hurricane had passed, possibly Saturday, and put everybody in jeopardy. It's nice to have them up here in Tigerville. We welcome them. We welcome everybody in the stands on the other side that's supporting the Citadel. And we appreciate any of you that's watching on the North Greenville Sports Network, along with our regular Crusader fans. We hope to bring you a great game tonight.
And it should be a great game. This Citadel team, speaking of them, they are pretty good themselves, ranked number 9 in the FCS, in both of the FCS polls. Of course, both those polls being led by the unanimous favorite, North Dakota State, as they look for what must be their 7th or 8th championship in a row. But this Citadel team is pretty strong, led by head coach Brett Thompson. In his first season, has an unblemished record of 4-0, 3-0 out of the SoCon.
Right, Greg. The Citadel is only one of 8 remaining undefeated teams in the FCS so far, and there you are showing that they are worthy of being in that position.
And they are also, offensively speaking of their offense, we're going to see a lot of triple options, a lot of keeping the ball on the ground. They dominated time of possession in their last game against West Carolina, 43 minutes, 10 seconds in time of possession. So they will more than likely keep on the ground as much as possible.
Yeah, their quarterback serves basically as an extra running back. His legs suit him very well. He's going to run a lot more than he'll probably throw tonight. So North Greenville Crusaders will have to be ready to have those backs out there ready to be on those players.
Junior 6'1" junior quarterback number 19 Dominique Allen. He'll have 3 backs in the backfield with him, 2 A backs and a B back. 2 A backs starting tonight: Cam Jackson, number 18, and number 6 Reggie Williams. The B back, Tyler Renfrew, leads the team in all-purpose yards.
Yeah, they do have a lot of all-purpose. The Bulldogs 5 interceptions this year. Ranked first in the SoCon, and they're tied for 37th in the FCS.
They run that 3-4 defense, so that's something positive for North Greenville. They have seen a 3-4 defense as they run it as well. And so Brett, head coach for Citadel, Brett Thompson, actually has seen North Greenville before back when he was an offensive coordinator for 3 years, 2010 to 2013. And, of course, the team's vastly different in that since then.
Yeah. One of the things, Gray, that is going to be a key, I think, to tonight's game is Citadel has converted almost 50% of its third downs, and they're ranked first in the SoCon and 11th in FCS in that category.
And when you can convert those downs like that and keep your drives going, that really tires out the opposing defense.
Yeah, that will definitely be one of the keys tonight. I look for the North Greenville key to be Mason Sanders tonight. I look for him to get a lot more passes thrown his way. play. He hasn't had much of a presence this season, but he has come through in the clutch when they definitely needed his first down yardage.
Yeah, back in our last home game against Newberry, Newberry kept him pretty much under wraps. He did have a couple of catches late, but roughly for three and a half quarters, Newberry kept pretty good tight ropes on him. And last week against Mars Hill, you think North Greenville was a little upset about having lost two in a row. And unfortunately, Mars Hill was on the receiving end. 56-21, North Greenville won that matchup.
Yeah, I'd like to see the Crusaders use a little bit of backup quarterback Colin Steen tonight. We watched him early in the season, and he showed that he has that leg presence too. He can scramble out of the backfield when the other team's not ready. He gained quite a bit of yardage the first couple games of the year.
You know, Dave, we can't get this game underway until, of course, we mentioned that head coach for North Greenville, Jeff Farrington, a graduate of the Citadel class of 1982.
Yeah, he knows that team very well, and probably was looking forward to getting back to that campus.
And the three running backs for the Citadel, they have three of their running backs in the top seven. In the SoCon, Tyler Renfro is third at 83 yards per game. Reggie Williams sitting in fifth with 76.5 yards a game. Cam Jackson, 58.8 yards a game, sits seventh. So this 3-4 defense for North Greenville is going to have a tough task of trying to set the edge, but also keep an eye on if they go up the middle or just basically stick to your lanes in that case.
Right, they're going to have the spy out there looking for this quarterback. He does have a propensity to run.
And now we have Ansley Brock down on the sideline. She's caught up with head coach for North Greenville, Jeff Farrington, graduate of the Citadel.
Coach, it seems like there's a buzz on campus with the Citadel being in Greenville. Can you tell me what the morale of your players is like today?
Well, I think our guys are very excited to play. Anytime you get an opportunity to play a game in this sport, it's a fun time. And then to have an opportunity to play up, we were planning on going, taking a trip down there to be able to have them come in our home stadium. That's an honor for us.
Can you tell us what a practice looks like, not knowing where or when the game is going to play?
Well, we had our regular Monday practice expecting to go down there. Tuesday, we knew there was a chance there could be a change, but we had our regular Tuesday practice. After practice Tuesday, we found out that there would be a change of venue and the game was going to get moved up from Saturday to Thursday.
All right, last question, Coach. Through prior interviews from the Citadel coach, he had mentioned that your wide receiver, Mason Sanders, is going to be getting a lot of attention from his defense. Can you tell me how you plan to respond to that?
Well, hopefully we can run the ball a little bit. That always helps when you try to get the ball to your receivers. But, you know, we see that every week with the teams that we play. Mason draws a lot of attention. And as Will Hunter continues to develop and our other receivers continue to develop, we're able to maybe spread the ball around to some other guys. If they're putting two on him, that opens up some other things.
All right, thanks, Coach. Best of luck to you. All right, back to y'all.
Thanks, Ansley. And Dave, I think you called that one a little bit. Mason Sanders going to be the recipient of a lot of defensive back attention from the Citadel.
Yeah, I watched him in warm-ups, and he acted like he was ready. And I just had a feeling that he might be one of the go-to people today.
And we mentioned that the Citadel undefeated 4-0. This is the fifth time in program history they have been 4-0, and the first time since 1992. What'd they do in 1992? They won the SoCon and went into the FCS playoffs.
Yeah, they're showing that they're definitely a great team.
And they're coming off of another playoff appearance last season where they made it to the second round before falling to in-state rival Charleston Southern.
Right.
They come into tonight sitting in number 9 in FCS, so they're bent on going back to the playoffs and making a deeper run and trying to go for a championship.
They have the attitude to do it. And they brought a great contingency of fans on the other side of the field in the visitor stands. And we're very happy to see them here to see this game. Also have a sidebar, Gray. It's halftime on the other side of the hill. For those of you that may know, the Pepsi Stadium is on the other side of the hill from Yount Stadium here in North Greenville. We are at halftime in ladies soccer, and the score is tied at 1.
And that soccer game against fellow conference Carolina's opponent, Emmanuel. And after that game, they'll have men's soccer coming up. So both fields on this side of 414 in action tonight.
Full parking lot, I'm sure.
Oh, believe me. Yes, it is. Citadel schedule looks like after tonight they'll head back home to take on UTC before returning to the Upstate in 2 weeks to take on the Wofford Terriers. North Greenville Coach Farrington mentioned that they are playing up to the FCS, formerly known as the Division I AA, as you have divisions in the football. Now you have FBS, FCS, then Division II, Division III, so on from there.
Yeah, North Greenville Crusaders are probably happy to be here at Yount Stadium tonight. I believe their next home game was scheduled for October the 29th against Wingate, a 2:30 start. So the fans are going to get an extra game to watch. Once again, if you're in the stadium and you're listening to us, or if you're at home, we appreciate it. It's a beautiful night, hardly a cloud in the sky, very little wind, at least for now until the hurricane gets closer.
And another big difference between the Citadel and North Greenville is the Citadel started playing football. Their first season was 1905. North Greenville didn't start having a full-time football team until 1988.
Yeah, the school here in North Greenville and Tigerville is relatively new, but they definitely have put together a sports program and a lot of sports that have really come along now in the last couple of years.
And that they have mentioned that North Greenville is now 3-2 on the season after getting a win over rival Mars Hill. Citadel sitting at 4-0, trying to establish their position within the Southern Conference.
They're also sending a signal to the Gulf South Conference that when they come in there in a couple years, they're going to be a team to reckon with.
That's right, North Greenville is doing that. And another thing to mention, that North Greenville is not shy about playing up to the FCS level. Their last win against the FCS team was in 2013. They beat VMI, formerly out of the Big South. I think VMI moved up back to the SoCon, so interesting note there. Yeah. This is actually the third time that an FCS team has made the trip to Tigerville.
I'm sure the coaches have expressed that to the players, that they seldom have an opportunity to play above their level, and they definitely can learn. This would be a good learning experience for the players in North Greenville to see what it's like playing somebody just a little bit more expected to be talented. I'm sure they're equally talented, but they're ranked a little bit higher in a higher division. So it's a good opportunity for these guys.
Those previous two times that an FCS team has made the trip to Tigerville was Charleston Southern. Both times they made a trip up here in 05 and 07. Charleston Southern won both of those, but it was a little closer than most people think. And then another game to note, North Greenville played Georgia State back in 2005, who is now in the Sun Belt at the FBS level. But prior to 2010, there's no record of Georgia State having an official recorded history of a football team, so we're not quite sure where to place that. But just to note, North Greenville did play Georgia State. North Greenville marching band on the field, so we'll go ahead and step away as pregame ceremonies are underway.
Marching Crusaders play the North Greenville University alma mater. For tonight's game are NGU Army ROTC cadets from the Paladin Battalion. The NCO in command is Cadet Ethan Clark. Carrying the U.S. colors is Cadet Jordan Ferguson. Carrying the Army flag is Luke Cuneo. And the riflemen are Cadet Carrie Kirkland and Nathan Burton. Would you please remain standing for the presentation of our invocation for tonight's game, given by Dr. Alan McWhite, the director of the Center for Cross-Cultural Engagement and Global Leadership here at North Greenville, who is also a proud graduate of the Citadel.
Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, tonight we're very mindful of why we're here. We're aware that millions of people already have been or soon will be impacted by Hurricane Matthew. And Father, we pray tonight for the people of Cuba and Haiti and Jamaica and the Bahamas. And we pray for the people of Florida and Georgia and our own state of South Carolina. And Lord, we pray for our National Guard and first responders who will be putting their own lives at jeopardy as they seek to minister to those in need here in our own country. So, Father, we pray tonight for your mercy in the midst of this storm. And, Lord, we're reminded tonight that our ultimate security is found only in you. So, Lord, help us to trust in you as we seek to minister to those around us who are in need. Father, we also pray tonight for these athletes that will take this field. We pray your hand of protection upon them and the officials. And Lord, as we watch their abilities tonight, may we be reminded that every ability we have comes from you. And we thank you as our creator, our sustainer, and our redeemer. And we ask all this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Please join the marching crusaders under the direction of drum major Nicole Bridges. And gentlemen, please remove your hats as we honor America with the playing and singing of our national anthem.
Just about ready for football between North Greenville and the Citadel, just roughly about 6.5 minutes away. Dave, we got to take a look at this North Greenville offense for a minute. Ashton Hurd, since going out of the Newberry game with an apparent hand injury, it has been Tracy Scott's show, and against Mars Hill, he definitely cashed in, going for 14 rushes, 127 yards, and 2 touchdowns. For the freshman, so going up against this talented Citadel defense, it's going to be up to him and Will Hunter to try and pace the offense.
Yeah, that's right, Gray. Ashton Hurd did make an appearance last Saturday night. He had a couple rushes and was testing that hand, I think. And I believe he's going to be ready for tonight.
Ashton Hurd did have 10 carries, 56 yards. Not the Hurd performance we're accustomed to seeing, but good to see him out on the field and getting some playing time. Take a look at the Citadel lineups for a moment. Starting receivers tonight, number 83, Rudder Brown. Number 3, Jorian Jordan. Out on the offensive line tonight, number 73, Isaiah Pinson. Number 57, Kyle Weaver. center will be number 53, Tyler Davis. Number 63, Drew McIntyre at right guard. Right tackle, number 71, Nick Jeffries. We mentioned the quarterback tonight, number 19, Dominique Allen, and his legs, what they can do for the Citadel offense. And then the three backs, the two A-backs, Cam Jackson and Reggie Williams, and the B-back, Tyler Renew, who leads the team in all-purpose yards and continues to tack up the rushing totals for the Citadel. On defense tonight, the defensive line, number 92, Travis Johnson, 68, Ken Allen, and number 97, Jonathan King. And the linebacking core tonight, number 5, Joe Crochet, number 50, Miles Pierce, number 43, Tevin Floyd. And then at Bandit and Rover positions, we have two starters listed at the Bandit position, number 33, Quinlan Washington, or number 22, Dondre Copeland. And for Rover, number 7, Kalik Williams. And the secondary, number 21, Malik Diggs, number 11, Ben Roberts, and number 4, D. Delaney. For North Greenville, you've got the starting quarterback, number 10, Will Hunter. Listed to start is Ashton Herr, but don't be surprised if we see a lot of Tracy Scott and Simeon Bird tonight. Also got to throw Tristan Jackson in that mix. Tight end, number 88, Devon Turman. At the receiving positions, number 13, Mason Sanders. Number 12, Javon Smith. Number 7, Damaje Rooks. And then on the line, number 64, Caleb Harris. Number 66, Armand Lindsay. Number 73, Michael Thomas. At right guard, number 76, Casey Stewart. And right tackle, number 56, Cameron Stepp.
Taking the field, led by the big NGU flag.
And Citadel will, actually they are starting to come out of the visiting locker room, so the Citadel actually will take the field last as they still have the home team designation, as this was designated to be a home game for them. Down in Charleston from Johnson Haygood Stadium.
Great, I'm going to add another key to the North Greenville game tonight. Number 39, Matt Gravely. I got a feeling that with the defenses the way they are, Gravely's going to have a presence tonight with those field goal attempts.
Yeah, for sure, because Matt Gravely out of Pickens, South Carolina, following in his brother's footsteps, who also kicked here, Justin Gravely at North Greenville. Special teams could come up huge as Richard Witherspoon will be returning kicks, Nigel Gay returning punts. Richard Witherspoon got a punt return against Lenore Rhines. Who knows what could happen tonight? Captains meeting at midfield between both teams.
Yeah, that return, I believe, was for 100 yards.
It was. And here comes the Citadel onto the field.
Okay, so you're receiving. Okay, turn your back right there. Citadel here. Citadel will receive on this end. Hey, y'all have a great game. Good luck to you.
So the Citadel will get the ball to start us off. So that means we'll get to see North Greenville defense out first, and they are the last starting unit we have not gone over yet. First out on the field for North Greenville, number 91, Seth Lauder, number 90, Anthony Blair, number 8, Shaquan Burney, and linebackers tonight, number 43, Dalton Pilgrim, number 46, Eddie Studevance. Leading tackler for North Greenville, number 53, Sam Houston out of Easley, South Carolina. And then rounding out the linebacking core, number 38, Quan Weeks. In the secondary, Tony Godbolt, number 15, number 20, KJ McDonald, number 4, Nigel Gay, and then number 1, Richard Witherspoon. Both of those last two gentlemen will be on special teams as well.
Citadel has already taken the field, and now the Crusaders are going to take the field, get ready for the first kickoff of the game here.
Matt Gravel is going to trot out. And he'll get us underway. Back deep for the Citadel, number 33, Quinlan Washington, as well as number 6, Reggie Williams. One of those A-backs for the Citadel.
Once again, we'd like to take this opportunity to thank you for being with us on the North Greenville Sports Network.
We are ready for the start.
We hope you'll enjoy tonight's game.
As well as those that might be listening on the campus radio station here at North Greenville University on WNGR LP 95.5 FM Tigerville. Gravely tees it up from his own 35. He's ready to send it away. And we are underway in Thursday night football here at North Greenville University. It'll be received by Washington. Washington to the 20, and he's upended as he falls forward to the 23-yard line. So first down and 10 for the Citadel. And Dave, we're ready to see triple option, a lot of rushing on the ground, and maybe even a few reverses throughout the night.
Yeah, be very cautious of that quarterback. He definitely likes to run with that ball. He's that extra option in the backfield now.
Citadel offense led by number 19, Dominique Allen. Allen under center, three backs in the backfield, two receivers out left from their own 23. Man goes in motion early. Allen, toss play to number 18, Cam Jackson. Jackson swings out to the far side, and he's brought down at the 26 after a three-yard pickup. So one play in, good job by North Greenville defense keying in on who has the ball.
North Greenville Crusaders safeties are playing up. They're not playing back for the long throw.
Allen back under center. Now two receivers go right. Man goes in motion. It's a handoff. It's an option play out to the far side, and lots of running room for Cam Jackson again as he rolls out to the 46-yard line. First down conversion for the Bulldogs.
Down by number 4, Nigel Gay. And number 27, Hunter Campbell.
Nigel Gay in on the tackle for North Greenville. First and 10 from the north from their own 46. A Citadel driving as the officials hold play. No flags on the field. And now we play on. Allen back under center. Two receivers roll right. Three backs still in the backfield. Man goes in motion, and it's a handoff this time up the middle to the B-back. And he gets across midfield into North Greenville territory at the 49. So that was number 36, Tyler Renew, on the carry.
Bulldogs are definitely using the running game. Get ready now, because I think they're getting set for the passing league startup.
Allen gets the snap, fakes the handoff, option play out to the near side again. Number 6, Reggie Williams, will be stopped a yard short of the first down at the North Greenville 45, and this will bring up third down and short. Two receivers go left for the Citadel. Allen back under center here on third down and 1. North Greenville stacking 6 up on the line. Allen gets a snap, handoff to Renew, straight up the middle, and he has a first down 2 yards to the good down to the North Greenville 42. And when you've got a back like the senior Renew, all you have to do is hand off, and he takes all 217 pounds and just burrows through the line. Allen back under center again, same formation as before. North Greenville looking to bring pressure. Now Quan Weeks steps back into his position. Allen gets the snap, handoff to Renew, and dragging a defender with them. Renew is brought down at the 37-yard line. Good pickup of around 6 yards.
Citadel front line is definitely showing their presence tonight. pretty much taking control of this line of scrimmage.
One receiver left now. Man goes in motion early, and the Citadel's going to throw it. Allen goes over. The pass is dropped. Intended for number three, Jorian Jordan. And the pass was on target. Jordan went up for it, just couldn't reel it in.
Yeah, he actually beat the defender, but I believe he was going to go to the ground anyway if he did catch it.
Now third down and five for the Citadel after the incompletion. And for the Citadel quarterbacks, that is only the 33rd pass attempted this season. Two receivers left. Allen back under center. Man goes in motion. They fake the handoff. The handoff to Renew. The B back up the middle, and he will be very close to the first down. And it looks like he did not get it. It will be fourth down for the Citadel, but they're close enough at the North Greenville 33. They might as well go for it.
Yeah, this is where you'll see that quarterback option, Greg.
Two receivers left. See Allen run it for the first time tonight. And he will. Quarterback keeper straight up the middle. Allen breaks free to the 20, dragging Nigel Gay with him. And Gay finally brings him down at the 10. And it will be first and goal for the Citadel behind their quarterback, junior Dominique Allen, leading the way.
Yeah, Allen had a big hole right up the middle that time. Nobody touched him until he got in the secondary.
First down and goal to go from the 10 for the Citadel. Allen back under center, gets the snap, handoff to Renew, straight up the middle, not much room to work with. They give him progress down to the 7. That's about a three-yard pickup. It'll be second down. Quan Weeks in on the tackle for NGU. Citadel gets set again here for second down, and they adjust the down marker to second down and 8, so 2-yard pickup for Renew. Allen gets a snap again, handoff to Renew again, and again he's bottled up as he gets a couple more yards. He's down just outside the 5, and that's going to bring up third down and goal, but the Citadel has not had any trouble converting third or fourth down tonight here on this first drive.
Yeah, this would be a great time for the Crusaders to stop here. Even if they allow the field goal, it will be a victory for the first set.
One receiver left. They do have a one-on-one matchup against Rachar Witherspoon. See if Allen wants to throw it. And he'll keep it off the right side. Cuts it back up the middle and will be stood up at the goal line. He didn't get in. That'll bring up fourth down and 1 as somebody's helmet came off at the end. That was Allen's helmet that came off, so he'll have to go out for a play.
Yeah, not a good time for the Bulldogs to have to bring in a quarterback that hasn't played any of this game. We'll see what they can do here.
And looks like they're Coach Thompson keeping the special teams on the sideline. Citadel's going to line up and go for it.
Yeah, this quarterback might have passer in mind, too.
Number 10, Jordan Black, now in the game. He'll go under center. Three backs close to the line behind him. Black gets the snap, hand off to Renew, straight up the middle, and no call yet. And he did not get in. North Greenville with the goal line stand holds the Citadel.
Yeah, moral victory for the Crusaders. Now that it's their turn to show the Bulldogs what they can put together and see if they can drive down the field.
And you're going to be down at your own 1. And the ball's actually spotted just inside the 1, but luckily just enough outside the goal line. And now number 10, Will Hunter, gets a chance to show what he's made of. Two receivers right, and now Hunter goes under center, looking to get a little bit of breathing room, pushes forward, and maybe got a yard at best to make it sink it down at 9, just trying to get out from his goal line. Nose of the football right at the 2. Credit Hunter with a 1-yard gain. Second down and 9. Two receivers right again. Hunter back under center. Or he's in the shotgun this time. He'll fake the handoff, throws, pass complete to his man at the 25-30, 35-40. Gone to midfield and into Citadel territory. Running free is number 12, and that will be a touchdown for North Greenville as Javon Smith goes the distance.
Looked like 99 yards on the play, Gray. Exactly what the Crusaders needed. Send a message to the Bulldogs that they're not planning to come in here and just take over the North Greenville campus. This is Crusader territory, and they're showing it now.
Nothing like the quick slant route designed to get you 5, maybe 10 yards. Javon Smith takes it the distance, and now Matt Gravely looks at the PAT, and it doesn't clear the field house, but it is good. So North Greenville leads the Citadel early, 7-0. And after that one play, Citadel's 76 yards of total offense, all of those yards on the ground. North Greenville, with that one pass play, racked up 98 yards, as they do have one rush yard on the ground. So the trend early looking good for North Greenville.
Yeah, it only took two plays for them to get on the board. Give North Greenville something to work on now. Bring that defense back on the field. They should be all fired up.
That again was Will Hunter connecting with Javon Smith. It's not as readjusted. You were right, Dave. That was a 99. Now that should be a 98. Passing touchdown from Hunter to Javon Smith as Hunter got a yard on the ground. So 98 yards to the air on 1 yard on the ground for NGU. Back deep again for the Citadel to return this kick. Quinlan Washington and number 6, Reggie Williams. Matt Gravely set to tee it up from his own 35. A two-play drive, 99 yards, took 43 seconds off the clock for North Greenville.
Matt Gravely puts it on the tee for the Crusaders. Beat the Citadel, number 6, Reggie Williams. And the third period, Portland, Washington.
Gravely ready to kick it away.
See if he can put this one in the end zone.
Pretty decent return last time out for the Citadel. A sideways spinning kick will go into the end zone, but it will be brought out by Washington. Washington to the 15, makes a good cut at the 20, gets to the 30, 35, 40, where he's finally brought down, and he fumbles the ball. And the officials come in to call him down, as that one looked like it rolled out of bounds anyway. So the Citadel, another strong return, will set up shop at their own 41.
Matt Gravely on the stop. He was the last line of defense to keep him out of the end zone. He slowed him down just enough to get him into the sideline.
Matt Gravely is a kicker that's not afraid to get his hands dirty. So the Citadel went 76 yards and came away with no points on their first drive. Stopped at the 1. Dominique Allen back out on the field after his helmet came off on the third down play. One receiver out wide. Allen goes under center. A handoff to the B-back. Gains a few yards, 2 yards, and 3 yards out to the 44.
He's stopped by number 53, Sam Houston.
And Sam Houston again getting in on the tackling.
And a two on the play, 2nd and 8 for the Citadel.
That was number 34 on the carry, Evan McField. Allen back under center, now two receivers. Man stutter steps in motion as they look to run that triple option. He gets back set. Now they start him in motion again. A handoff to number 6, straight up the middle. And again, second straight tackle for Houston as the Citadel gains a few more yards out to the 47. And that was Reggie Williams on the carry for 3. Third down again for the Citadel as they face a third down and three. One receiver right, one left. McField the B-back. Allen under center. Allen hands off, and now they'll run to an option play to number 18, Cam Jackson. Jackson has the first down, continues to drag tacklers with him. A flag comes out, and Jackson will be down at the North Greenville 32 as we will wait and figure out what this flag is for.
Great option play that time by the Bulldogs. Had everybody looking up the middle. They thought, sure, that's where he was going.
By the defense. 15 yards added to the end of the run. First down.
Grabbing a face mask penalty against North Greenville will tack on an extra 15 to that run and put Citadel in prime position again. And that just proves how potent this triple option offense is for the Citadel. Is you can't forget about the pitch man. Allen back under center with two receivers, two A-backs and a B-back, as Allen looks to throw again, drops back, throws to the far side, looks to the end zone, and overshoots his man out of the back of the end zone, looking again for Jorian Jordan.
Allen 0 for 2 on the game so far. We're at the 7:02 mark. Only two attempted passes. We thought it was going to be a ground game tonight anyway, Gray.
Second down and 10 from the North Greenville 16 for the Citadel. Allen back under center with one receiver split out very wide right as another option play, and Allen somehow got the pitch off and running into the end zone. Touchdown for number 6, Reggie Williams, one of those A-backs. Looked like initially North Greenville was going to be able to blow that play up before it got started, but Allen, with a defender around his legs, pitched it at the last possible moment, and Reggie Williams takes it in for the first Bulldog touchdown. Kicking tonight for the Citadel is number 87, Cody Clark. Kicking out the hold of number 90, Will Vanvick, as he sends it up, and it is good. And just a few minutes later, we are tied at 7. Between the Citadel and North Greenville, primarily North Greenville's offense through the air. And as you just saw there, the Citadel keeping it on the ground as they have now reached 119 yards and are just moving the ball at will down the field, pushing it against the North Greenville defense.
Crusaders number 98, Desmond Williams, went as high as he could that time. He's got a couple blocks, extra points and blocked field goals this year, and I think he tried to get one there. He went as high as he could.
Yeah, he got one in the very first game of the season. That was the difference maker in the score against the game against West Alabama. That was his first one, and I think the other one was against Newberry when he reached up and got his second extra point block of the season. So Desmond Williams proving to be a special teams force for North Greenville.
Yeah, I think he's also got a field goal attempt block too.
So now North Greenville will come back. We'll send their offense back onto the field in just a moment as soon as we see the kickoff return, the return on the kickoff. Number 86, the place kicker for the Citadel, Jacob Gadeck, will kick it away from his own 35. Back deep for North Greenville. Coach Farrington elects to send three return men back deep. Richard Witherspoon anchors in the middle as he is flanked by number 47 to the right. That is Latif Hughes, a running back. And number 7, Damaje Rooks, the wide receiver, to his left.
Need to remind Witherspoon he's got 100 yards in front of him to take it in.
The official talking with Gadeck at his own 35, now heads to the sideline, so Gadeck will boot this one away. Also have to be mindful of the Citadel might be looking for the onside kick as they now spread their return team out. Nothing changes momentum around early in a game like a onside kick no one's expecting. Gaudette to his own 35 will boot this one deep, and Witherspoon, 5 yards deep into his end zone, will take a knee. So that will bring it out to the 25. No chance on a return for that one as Gaudette put all of his foot into that one, and Witherspoon had no shot at the return.
Yeah, that was a wise move. They had the field very well covered in every lane.
Well, North Greenville went 99 yards on their first drive for a touchdown. A quick strike from Will Hunter to Javon Smith. Two plays is all they needed. Let's see if they what kind of sustained drive they can put together.
We're at 6:56 in the first quarter now here in Titanville.
Tracy Scott gets a start at tailback on this drive. He'll be to the right side of Hughes. Two receivers left, two right from the North Greenville 25. Hunter gets a snap, drops back, looks to the near side. Pass complete to Demaje Rooks, and Rooks shoved out of bounds right at the first down marker. And that's right at the 35, so it looks like he got it. And that will be a first down for North Greenville.
Push down around the 35, 36-yard line. That's good.
One play, 10 yards.
Yeah, Rooks got up a little slow on that one, but it looks like he's all right on the sideline, just getting a breather.
Pistol set for Hunter with the tailback behind him. That's Scott. Three receivers for him to throw it. He hands off to Scott, and Scott, a big hole up the middle, trying to break free of two Citadel tacklers as Scott rumbles out to the 48 for a 13-yard pickup and another first down. Nose of the football just shy of the NGU, 49, first and 10. The tight end, Pedro Maginault, that's number 88, Devon Terman in the backfield. Hunter gets a snap. They run Scott to the right side. Scott looking for a hole, has one, gets to the 45, and dragged down a yard short of the first down for a 9-yard pickup to the Citadel 42.
They have about nine on the play. Turn the tackle in the middle, 43, Kevin Floyd. Second and short for the Crusaders.
And here comes a short yardage back on number 35, Tristan Jackson. He is a bruiser here in on the second down and one. Four receivers for Hunter in the pistol set with Jackson behind him. He'll get the snap, look the throw, looks right, throws right, and pass dropped. Intended for, looking again for Javon Smith, and that will bring up third down and one.
Yeah, great coverage that time by the Bulldogs. The Crusaders, I think, was calling for an early interference foul, but that was a good play.
So third down and one. Citadel probably going to be expecting run. See how many they stack up in the box. They go five linemen up front, three linebackers, so they're expecting a run. Hunter pistol set. Scott now in the ball game, hands off to Scott, and Scott's going to go nowhere. He'll lose a yard back to the North Greenville 43, or the Citadel 43. And that will bring up fourth down and decision time for North Greenville. Citadel went for it on fourth down. Looks like North Greenville's getting ready to do the same.
Yeah, early in the game, this is a good time to go ahead and test your offense, see if they've got it where they can get that 3 yards now.
They switch Scott for Jackson, and two receivers left, two right. Hunter drops back in the shotgun, Jackson to his right. Fourth down and three. Hunter gets a snap, looks to pass, throws, pass complete, and dropped. Incomplete, as number nine had it, Christian Bruce, and then he coughed it up, and North Greenville will turn it over on downs. North Greenville lucky that one wasn't ruled a fumble.
Yeah, he should have had that one. He had it in his arms. He just couldn't make a football move after he came down with the ball. Again, good defense by the Bulldogs.
First down and 10 for the Citadel from their own 44. Last drive for them, it was Reggie Williams taking it to the house. Allen back under center. They send Williams in motion. Hand off to Renew straight up the middle, and he's twisting his way as he spins from the line of scrimmage for 4 yards. They may give him three out to the 47. So Renew, he gets hit at the line of scrimmage, but he's so tough that he spins away and drags tacklers with him. 3 yard pickup, second down and 7. Two receivers, one right, one left. Allen under center, North Greenville. Signal pressure, Weeks backs out of it. Allen goes under center as it is a handoff and going nowhere, falling forward for 1, maybe 2 yards is Renew again. North Greenville was ready for it as Weeks came back up a second time, and they had, North Greenville had 6 defenders at the line.
Yeah, it was good defense on the Crusaders. Now they got to wake the safeties up.
Third down and 5 for the Citadel from their own 30, from their own 49. One receiver right, one bunched up left. Now they bring both receivers in to bunch them up. Allen back under center, drops back to pass, looks to the right side, throws, has a man open, and overthrows him. Looking for number 2, DeAndre Schultz, and that'll bring up 4th down.
Yeah, it looked like Witherspoon on the coverage. The Bulldog player got open, but Witherspoon caught up with him very quickly.
Well, that'll bring up 4th down and 5, and the Citadel on with the special teams unit to kick it away. Number 90, Will Van Vick, the punter out of Greenville, J.L. Mann High School. High snap, Van Vick brings it down. North Greenville rushes 3 as Van Vick gets a good kickoff that's going to take a hop into the end zone and will be a touchback to the North Greenville 20-yard line.
It was our first chance to see the punting team for the Bulldogs. And he definitely has a leg. He got it completely into the end zone. There was no chance it could have been down on the 1 or 2.
So here early as we wind our way to the end of the first quarter, 3:33 left to go. We're tied up at 7. North Greenville struck first. 98 touchdown pass from Will Hunter to Devon Smith. The Citadel answered with Reggie Williams on a rushing carry as that has brought us to the 7-7 score we sit at. North Greenville playing up a level to the FCS level as they normally have 1 game a season where they do this. Just a different venue this time. As Hunter in the pistol set, hands it off to Scott, and Scott able to work his way through traffic for a yard, and the Citadel's rush defense has definitely come to play.
I'm real surprised, Gray, that we haven't seen Mason Sanders on any of these plays.
Mason Sanders lining up on the left side of the line. Citadel might be trying to put a double coverage on him. 2 receivers go right, pistol set for Hunter. Gets a snap, fakes the handoff, looks Sanders' way, now turns back right, throws a laser beam that is caught. And Javon Smith again has the first down to the North Greenville 43. They might be focusing on Sanders so much, so that's opening up opportunities for other North Greenville receivers.
Yeah, definitely Hunter looked to the left, and that brought some of the defenders this way and left him open on the far side.
2 receivers left, Sanders over to the right. Citadel looking to bring pressure. They do. Hand off to Scott, and he runs right into that pressure and loses a whole bunch of yardage back to the North Greenville 38. Citadel ready for that play as they brought pressure off the left side of the North Greenville line. Now second down and 15. 2 receivers left, 2 right. Hunter lining up, barking out a hard count. Still has 15 seconds on the play clock. Tracy Scott lining up behind him. Citadel with 4 downed linemen as Hunter drops back in the shotgun now. Gets the snap, drops back, throws a quick pass that is incomplete. Over to the far side, intended for Javon Smith again. And that looked like it might have been a miscommunication as Smith stopped in his route. And one of the tight ends kept running down the field as now it's third down and long. North Greenville needs to get to the Citadel 47. Two receivers left, two right. Citadel again stacking up the box. Hunter, pistol set. 10 seconds on the play clock. Looking back to the sideline. Now 5 seconds on the play clock. 2 seconds. Hunter's got to get it off one. Play clock hits zero as he gets the snap. Citadel brings pressure, and Hunter's going to be sacked back at the 25.
Yeah, Hunter wasn't ready for that. It looks like he was still looking at the sidelines. And he knew the clock was going down, so he had to get something going, and they just didn't have the play set up.
Number 92, Travis Johnson, the first man there, as the defensive line on that drive overpowering North Greenville. As their nose tackle for the Citadel is 282. The closest player to that on the line for North Greenville is actually 285, Casey Stewart and Cameron Stepp, but the Citadel working very well on the line tonight. Bobby Foose on to kick it away. And a low wobbly kick that will force number two back for the Citadel. This one's returnable to the 35 and shoved out of bounds at the 39 was DeAndre Schultz on that return. So the Citadel has it first down and 10 again, looking for the lead.
Yeah, good coverage again for the Crusaders. Everybody was in their lane. That was a low kick and actually drove the receiver back, and that's what set up the chance for the defenders to get in there and make a good tackle.
First down and 10 from their own 39 for the Citadel. Allen back under center where he's been most of the night. Hands off to the B-back, Renew, straight up the middle, and best run of the night for him as he picks up 7 yards to the Citadel 46-yard line. So second down and 3 to go.
On the tackle for North Greenville. Second and 3.
One receiver right. Bunched up one on the left as well. Another handoff to the B-back Renew as he falls forward to the first down. And it looks like he got it. Another solid run for the B-back Renew as he will have 3 yards on a Citadel first down.
That's good for Citadel, first and 10.
Just a quick update on the Lady Crusaders soccer on the other side of the hill. They're under 3 minutes to go and the score is still 1-1.
It's like a timeout called, and nope, that will be the end of the first quarter. So at the end of one, both teams have reached the end zone once as we are tied between North Greenville and the Citadel at 7 apiece. So far, I believe the game's living up to the expectations, to the hype for tonight's contest. So tied at 7, we'll step away for a timeout, bring you back to the second quarter here on the North Greenville Sports Network. Second quarter here between the Citadel and North Greenville. The Citadel switches ends of the field, will now go from right to left, and they're all dark or very dark gray uniforms. North Greenville in what would normally be what is their road white, all white uniforms with red trimmings as North Greenville is the away team. Citadel, the home team here at Yount Stadium. Allen back under center here on first down and 10. Hands off to Renew. Renew bottled up again, but keeps turning for 2 yards into North Greenville territory to the 49.
Bulldogs have got to figure out very soon that that middle's clogging up and they're going to have to move that option to the outside.
Second down and 8. Allen drops back under center. 2 receivers right. North Greenville, 5 down linemen up on the line. Toss play to number 31 with a hole on the left side. Big run down to the 20, 15, 10. Race for the goal line, and he is in. Yes. Citadel touchdown from number 31, Rod Johnson, out of 96, South Carolina.
Yeah, there's that option play to the near side. I had a feeling it was time for that.
So the Citadel has taken their first lead of the night. And they're going to line up in a swinging gate formation. The special teams unit on the field, and now they bring it in as the play clock runs. Number 80 on to kick the PAT. Or number 90, that is Van Vick again. Kick on its way, and it is good. So the Citadel leads at 14-7 after that PAT from number 87. I'll get it right eventually. Cody Clark, he was kicking out of the hold of Van Vick. So the Citadel leads at 14-7. They've tried to complete 3 passes so far. They haven't completed a pass yet, but all their yards have come on the ground.
Yeah, that wishbone offense reminds me back in the day when Texas used to run that very efficiently.
Now you have schools like Paul Johnson down at Georgia Tech. He likes a triple option. You have Navy running it. Air Force likes to do it. Those two Armed Forces academies like to keep it on the ground. And the Citadel following suit. Charleston Southern, also another triple option team. And North Greenville, it's not like they're complete strangers to that type of offense. That's what Lenore Ryan for a good number of years. That's what they ran when head coach Brett Thompson was their offensive coordinator for 3 years. And Carson Newman, the school North Greenville also plays on a regular basis. They like to do the same thing.
Crusaders are going to have to look to get Ashton Hurd back in there and possibly Simeon Bird as well.
So far it's been Tracy Scott, and we've seen Tristan Jackson on the field as well. Hunter is credited with a rushing attempt, 2 rushing attempts, as he was sacked on 1 play and rushed for 1 yard as well, but a negative yardage credited to Will Hunter so far. Now the Citadel's going to kick it off from the near side hash mark. Number 86, Jacob Gadeck, on to kick it away. And change in the return game for North Greenville as Gadeck sends a high spinner. This one will be returnable for NGU. And that's Javon Smith looking to get a return, and he will get flattened at the 16 as he had nowhere to go. Host of Bulldogs back there to greet him, number 38, Noah Dawkins, one of those, as well as number 23, Tyus Carter.
Have to give the props to the Bulldogs special teams. They definitely are covering their lanes very well on these kickoffs and punts.
North Greenville facing a deficit for the first time tonight. Two receivers go right, 2 left. Hunter in the pistol set with Simeon Bird in at tailback. Hunter calls for the snap, will run Bird to the right side as he gets met in the backfield and dropped for a loss. 3 yard loss for Bird as Citadel calling for the fumble as a Crusader slow to get up. It's a 3 yard loss. North Grand will face a second down and 13 as the training staff comes out to take a look at the injured Crusader. So timeout called on the field. Almost a full minute into the second quarter. So far, the Citadel almost at 200 total yards of offense, all 196 of those yards on the ground. North Greenville sitting at 137, all but six of those through the air, as the Citadel has already seen six different offensive players take a rush. Tyler Renew leads the way with 11. Rod Johnson, who just scored the go-ahead touchdown to take the lead, has two attempts. Cam Jackson's had three. Quarterback Allen's had two. Williams with three and McField with one. So the Citadel keeping it on the ground but spreading it around as we expected.
I really expected Allen to have more plays than what he's had so far in this game. They may be saving him for the second half.
Yeah, North Greenville's has had several negative rushing yard plays. As they've got to get the ground game revitalized. And that was Bird who's getting helped off the field. And not putting a lot of pressure, not putting any pressure on that left leg. So Bird to the sideline, Tracy Scott back in at tailback. Number 81, Pedro Maginault out to the far side at receiver. Two receivers to the right for Hunter in the pistol set with Scott behind him. He'll fake the handoff, roll out, throws, pass complete. And the official threw his hat as that's normally a sign as he was forced out but came back in. They will give credit to the 22-yard line. That was Christian Bruce again on the reception. Third down and a long four for NGU from their own 23-yard line. Play clock running down. It's at 10. Hunter changing things up. Drops back in the shotgun. Christian Jackson in at tailback. Hunter gets the snap off. Looks to the far side. Lobs it up and completes the pass to number 81. Pedro Maginault. Good enough for the first down. That's a play you run where your receiver is mindful of where the first down. Maginault went 2 yards past. Turned. Pass complete. First down.
Yeah, impressive. It looked like Hunter passed that ball off his wrong foot. He was back on the back foot instead of the front foot when he let go of that pass, but it was right on target.
So Pedro Maginault gets credited for a reception, a receiver out of Goose Creek, South Carolina. As two receivers go left, one right, tight end in the backfield with Hunter and Scott. Scott gets the handoff as he rumbles right into a Citadel linebacker. And gets forward to the 33, so a 4 yard pickup on first down.
Yeah, good defense again. Boy, it was like Scott hit a brick wall when he came through there.
And that brick wall was number 43, Tevin Floyd. Second down and six from their own 33. Three receivers right, Hunter in the pistol. It's the snap. Again, another handoff to Scott. Scott able to escape the initial pressure and gets tracked down from behind. He'll still lose a yard as Citadel with great pursuit. Number 50, Miles Pierce, tracks him down from behind, and that forces a third down and seven.
Out of Daphne, Alabama.
Two receivers left, two right. Citadel looking to rush all three linebackers. They back out of it. And Hunter's got to be ready for the all-out blitz. Play clock down to five. drops back in the pistol. Two on the play clock. Hunter gets the snap off in time. Here comes pressure. It's complete. Out to the running back, Tristan Jackson. Breaks free and gets enough for the first down to the North Greenville 41. What a move from Jackson right at the first down marker to make sure he had enough and fake out the cornerback over there here on the near side.
Uncharacteristic for Jackson to get that many yards. He's usually the short yardage guy.
North Greenville will take it as they have a fresh set of downs from their own 41 is where Jackson got him. He'll stay in the ball game. Three receivers bunched up left. Hunter with the tight end, Terman, to his left. It's a snap. Handoff to Ashton Hurd. Runs right into his own lineman and gets slung down for another loss on the play. We have a flag out from the far side linesman.
Illegal motion, number 81 of the offense. The penalty is declined. Second down.
Illegal motion that time. I think 81 was just not quite ready for the snap.
Penalty is declined as it was another negative running play for North Greenville. Puts it at second down and 14. Hunter still looking to the sideline. Now late man comes on for North Greenville. They've got to get set. Five on the play clock. Hunter in the pistol, looking, pointing, and play clock's at zero.
Yeah, Hunter's going to complain. The referee was still over the ball when the play clock was going down, and the referee hadn't marked the ball in play. I think they're going to get get it on the Crusader side this time. I think they're going to be okay.
Timeout.
Well, North Greenville forced to call a timeout. That's the first timeout used by either team. As the officials are going to talk about that as North Greenville huddles up to the sideline. Citadel huddles up on theirs here on second down and 14. Dave, while we have this chance to mention it, North Greenville, due to the hurricane that is sweeping up the East Coast, North Greenville is opening up the dorms to anybody who needs a place to ride out the storm away from the coast. So if you know anybody that needs a place to stay for a few days, get in touch with Student Life here at NGU as soon as possible. Hunter pistol set here on second down and 14. Two receivers right. Ashton Hurd in the backfield. Hunter fakes the handoff, looks down the field, has Maginault, and overshoots him. And North Greenville sideline wanting a pass interference call. They won't get it as a defender was step for step.
Yeah, that could have been a pass interference on either player. They were definitely doing hand exchanges.
You'll have that with running a seam route like Maginault did down the field. Lots of hand checking. Officials let him play on. And we'll have third down and 14.
I haven't seen Mason Sanders on the field in this period.
Two receivers right, two left. Receiver comes in motion across the line. Hunter gets a snap, looks, throws, sets up the screen to Hurd and overthrew him. Fourth down on the incompletion. And North Greenville, the drive stalls again, and here comes Bobby Fuson to kick another punt away. Back deep for the Citadel, number two, DeAndre Schultz, who has had two good returns tonight, has set up wonderful field position for the Citadel.
And we're right at the 10-minute mark in the second period.
Low snap to Foose, scoops it up out of the turf, didn't have any rush, and Foose still gets a good kickoff. It's caught at the 15 by Schultz. Schultz brings it to the near side, to the 25-30, cuts it up, has a hole, and he's twisted down at the 42. Oh, again, stellar field position for the Citadel from their own 42 as they have started two drives from past the 40-yard line.
Crusaders have to be very careful now. Make sure that Allen doesn't take off. Dominique Allen got those legs.
One receiver left, one right. Allen changes the play, drops back under center. They send a man in motion and hand it off to number six, straight up the middle. And he doesn't go down at first contact, and he sprints for 10 yards. Reggie Williams on the carry for a first down.
Number 53, Sam Houston, and number 27.
First and 10 from the North Greenville 48-yard line for the Citadel. Two receivers, Allen under center. Changing things up at the line. Gets the snap, hands it off to his B-back straight up the middle. And for 3 yards, rumbles number 34, Evan McField, for another carry as it'll be second down and 7.
Boy, the Bulldogs, their backs will get 3 yards, seem like almost every play that they hand off to those A and B backs.
And if you pick up 3 yards a clip, you go four downs, that's 2 yards to the good for a first down. Man goes in motion. It's a toss play to the far side to Williams. Williams has the first down, looking for more, and gets tripped up as he crosses the 30 down to the 29-yard line as North Greenville didn't set the edge, and the Citadel almost ran away with it.
Bulldogs looking to add on to more points now, leading the game 14-7 with 8:27 left in the first half.
Allen drops back under center. Man comes in motion. North Greenville brings pressure. Handoff to McField up the middle, and he twists for 2 yards just inside the NGU 27-yard line. So that'll be second down and 8 to go.
Anthony Blair on the stop for the Crusaders. Second and 8.
Two receivers again, the formation. Allen looks for the snap. Gets it, turns around, hands off to one of his A-backs, runs across the line and gets inside the 25 down to the 23, goes Cam Johnson. For a 4-yard pickup, that'll be third down and 3. Third down and 4. Citadel might try another toss play. Allen back under center. And they'll hand it off to it's a keeper by Allen, and he does get the first down. He's still going. He's inside the 15 and dragging half the defense with him down into the 11-yard line.
Wow, impressive with the legs. He picked up an extra 5 yards with two or three defenders hanging all over him.
And you can see the linebackers just hanging on, but Allen just taking them for the ride. Timeout on the field again. Something wrong with the chains on the far side. Had trouble getting the chain set. 7 minutes to go in the second quarter. Citadel driving, looking to go up 2 scores. Two receivers, Allen lines it up under center. Back to his left, back to his right, back behind him. And another keeper by Allen, looks for the hole, finds what he can. And he gets inside the 10, down to the 8 for a 3-yard pickup.
He's tackled by number 93, Rashad Miller. Second down for the Bulldogs.
Second down and 7 from the North Greenville 8. Same formation. Allen lets the play clock run, gets a snap, hands off to his B-back. No, he pitches it out to Williams on the far side. North Greenville pursues him, and the ball comes free. And North Greenville says they have it. And
waiting for the referee's confirmation.
They're going to try to unpile the players. Still haven't seen a signal. Well, it is Crusader football.
Yeah, the players are changing for both teams. Now they're moving to change.
That time, North Greenville set the edge, and right as Reggie Williams stopped to make a cut, Sam Houston came from the side and knocked the ball free. Number 9 team in the country in the FCS polls, the Citadel playing on the road at North Greenville, but the Citadel still a home team, as this was supposed to be a home game down in Charleston. North Greenville's offense back out on the field, first down and 10 from their 10. Hunter in the gun, drops back, quick throws out, and incomplete as it was batted away, intended for number 7, Demaje Rooks.
Pass throw to number 2, Demaje Rooks.
Dave, something to notice the Citadel starting to do is those first couple of North Greenville drives, as they were playing very soft coverage. Since then, they have brought their defensive backs up and are playing, it looks almost man-to-man out there. Hunter in the pistol, three receivers right, looks that way, still looking, is going to throw one up, has a man down the sideline, and it is caught. Javon Smith off to the races again, down to the 20, 15, 10, 5, and he does it again. Touchdown, North Greenville, on a 90-yard pass that time.
Yeah, 2 for 2 now on those long passes. He definitely beat the defender. He had him beat by 20 yards.
First time it was a slant route. That time it was right down the seam. Javon Smith outruns everybody. And Matt Gravely on for the tying extra point. Snap is down from Dalton Pilgrim. Kick is up. It is good, and we are tied at 14.
That was exactly what the Crusaders needed to go tie it up before they went in at halftime. Still a lot of football left, 5:39 to go in the first half.
And I don't think these two teams could be any more different if they tried to. All of Citadel's offense has been on the ground, 234 yards of it. North Greenville has gotten all but 2 yards through the air. 246 through the year, a total of 248 for North Greenville. As it looks like we're in another offensive shootout.
Yeah, I think the moon is even enjoying this, smiling right over the 50-yard line.
A good crescent moon out here overlooking Yount Stadium.
I have to give accolades, too, to the Bulldogs faithful on the far side. The stands are not only full, but they're lined up on the hill all the way from both sides, all the way down to the hedges.
It was announced after this game, after the announcement was made that this game would be moved upstate to be played here at NGU, it was announced a couple hours later that North Greenville would honor all tickets purchased by Citadel fans prior to today. All tickets would still be honored, so it looks like that has been the case, as Citadel has overflowed the visitor sideline, and even getting a good seating section over here on the home side.
Yeah, the Saturday game was supposed to be an early afternoon Parents' Day game down at the Citadel. So the parents probably had a lot of tickets, and they thought, well, we're going to have to evacuate anyway. Let's just go up there and watch a good football game at Tigerville.
Governor Haley also reversing the southbound lanes of, or eastbound lanes, if you will, of I-26 to send all traffic north toward Columbia and try and get as many people out of the low country as possible.
I thought you were going to say she was here in attendance, but it wouldn't surprise me because she does some things like that.
As Matt Gravely pooch kicks it to the near side, trying to keep it away from the Citadel return team, and a flag comes out as a fair catch was called for, and half the coverage team for NGU ran into the return man for the Citadel. Good strategy call to try and keep it away from number 33, Quinlan Washington, and who has been returning them tonight for the Citadel, but here's the penalty.
Even though the receiver muffed the ball and stayed in, it's another opportunity. Oh.
I think the North Greenville Crusaders saw him bobble the ball on the catch and thought it was a free play at that point. But the referees cleared that up for us.
So we've only been a pretty clean game so far, only two penalties. Both of them have been against North Greenville as Citadel will start from their own 48. Allen under center, fakes the handoff, pitches it to one of his B-backs, and off to the races goes number 18, Cam Jackson. Jackson all alone, and the Citadel's going to jump back out in front on one play. As Cam Jackson rumbles 52 for that one.
Now he certainly enjoys that triple option back there, this time to his right.
Number 87, Cody Clark back on for the extra point to put the Citadel back up seven. Snap is down for Clark, kick is up, and plenty of distance on this one, and it is good. The Citadel back up on top, 21-14.
Once again, still a lot of football left to play in this first half at 5:29 to go. We'll see if North Greenville can rally back again.
And here with 5:29 left to play in the second quarter. While we have a stoppage of time, I want to bring back something we did a few games a couple of seasons back. And I got a trivia question about the Citadel. And that is, what former ACC coach has ties to the Citadel? Again, what former ACC coach has coaching ties to the Citadel?
Will you agree? I can't answer that one for you.
We'll give you a few minutes to think about that, Dave. And
okay.
About doing some research on, looking up some information about the Citadel, and one name popped up that was pretty interesting to me. As the Citadel has been a target by many other schools. In fact, Brent Thompson took over for a previous coach who left to go to James Madison University.
Number 86, Jacob Godek, set to kick off for the Citadel.
Godek back on for the kickoff from his own 35. Richard Witherspoon drifts back deep at his own 4, anchors the middle. As Godek will send a high spinning kick, Witherspoon from his own 1 will have a chance to return it. Witherspoon cuts back at the 15 and gets dropped at the 17 as some extra pushing and shoving proceeds after the play. Officials quick to get in there and break it up. It's good to see the officials get on top of that as things got out of hand, a little bit out of hand in the Newberry game here a few weeks back. And Hurricane Matthew continues to put problems on for college football around the state of South Carolina. This just announced the South Carolina-Georgia game will be moved to Sunday due to the hurricane. As receiver comes in motion, Hunter in the pistol, gets a snap, hands it off to his tailback, Hurd. Hurd with a big hole right up the middle to the 35-40, and Ashton Hurd rumbles to the 44-yard line for North Greenville.
Yeah, there's Ashton Hurd. He's back. Just wanted to let everybody know that injury didn't last as long as they expected it, just a couple games.
Certainly good for the North Greenville offense to have Hurd back in that offense, and good for his confidence to be able to bust off a run like that. Hunter, three receivers back in the pistol, two left, one right. Drops back to pass, looks to the near side, and somehow manages to overthrow Mason Sanders, who's at 6'6", but he does, and it's incomplete, second down.
I think that's the first time he's actually gone to Sanders tonight.
That has been the first target for Sanders all night.
Actually, I think it's the first play that Sanders has been in the second half.
So two receivers right, it's Smith and Rooks. Sanders goes left this time. Hunter back in the pistol with Hurd behind him, a tight end to his left. Citadel looks to bring pressure off the edge. They do. Hurd gets flattened again as he falls forward to the 46-yard line. It's a pickup of two. It'll be third down and eight. Yeah, it was almost another negative play. Citadel brought a corner blitz. Third down and eight. North Greenville needs to get to the Citadel 46. Snap to Hunter. Going for the hard count. Now checks the sideline. He'll have three receivers right. Sanders matching up over on the far side, one-on-one. Tristan Jackson in at tailback. Hunter gets a snap, looks to pass, looks to the far side, throws it up for Sanders, and it is knocked away. Number four out there on coverage, D. Delaney forces fourth down and a punt for NGU.
That was great coverage by the Bulldogs with Sanders' height. He got clear up there to the ball and blocked it away at the last second.
So now Citadel with another chance to go up two scores as they look to receive this punt. Number two, DeAndre Schultz back deep. Bobby Foose to kick it away from his own 31. Good snap to Foose. The Citadel brings no pressure. Foose gets a high kickoff that's going to bounce at the six and roll into the end zone. But a little too much power under that one.
Yeah, it was a good effort. It just couldn't quite get there down at the 1 or 2 yard line. Very good effort, though. Good kick by Foose.
That'll bring the ball out to the 20-yard line for the Citadel, who, again, we expected this coming in, has no problem getting it on the ground. They are almost at 300 rushing yards, and we're not even done with the first half yet. Cam Jackson is the closest Bulldog to 100 yards. That's three different Bulldogs have put it in the end zone tonight.
We're just under 4 minutes in the first half.
Allen back under center. Handoff to the B-back, Renew, and he goes nowhere. And forward progress will be stopped after 1 yard at best pickup by Renew will be second down.
To the 38, Quan leads to number 90, Anthony Blair. Make the stop.
Anthony Blair getting in on the stop.
Second down.
Citadel gets back set here with 3.5 minutes to go. Two receivers right for Allen. Gets the snap again. And he options it out again. There goes number six, Reggie Williams, off to the races. And he gets around the edge again. First down for the Bulldogs. Out to their own 38-yard line. And Dave couldn't tell which Crusader that was in the backfield who almost intercepted the pitch.
Yeah, I think they're getting ready now. They're noticing that triple option and trying to put that spy out there. And if he sees that Allen's not going to carry the ball, he tries to go for it.
Two receivers now left as Allen drops back under center. Motion up on the line for North Greenville. Handoff to the B-back, Renew, and he's stopped again right at the line, this time for no gain. Number 41 for North Greenville, Randy Brown, gets in on the stop. Be second down and still 10 to go.
Bulldogs trying something different besides the option on that play.
One receiver, now lone man here on the left side. Man goes in motion as Allen looks for the pitch. He's going to keep it himself. North Greenville keeps the edge, but Allen still manages to sprint out for 5, maybe 6 yards. The clock continues to roll as the Citadel will have third down and medium.
Just now at the 2 minute mark.
And the Citadel not in any rush to get set here with third down. Looks like they might try, and now they get set here with 15 to go on the play clock. One receiver left. Allen drops under center. North Greenville looking to bring pressure. Allen calls it out to his line. Allen gets a snap. Handoff to Renew off the left side. He's dropped at the 45, and that will bring up fourth down as the clock continues to run. North Greenville's not going to call a timeout yet. They're going to let the clock run. They do have the option to receive the second half kickoff.
And they have two timeouts left in this half. I believe Coach Franklin's going to wait until...
I think they just burned one.
Oh, they might have. Okay. So they're going to see what kind of field position they get on this kickoff.
It'll be fourth down and four or three. The Citadel will be on to kick it away. With a minute 14 left, one timeout. Even if you don't get anything on this drive, you do. North Greenville does get the option to receive the second half kickoff, so we'll have to wait and see how everything plays out.
Be great to see the Crusaders go in tied at the half.
Citadel leads at 21-14 over North Greenville, ninth-ranked team in the country in the FCS polls. Citadel out of the SoCon, North Greenville Division II independent, set to join the Gulf South Conference full-time starting in 2018. Good snap to the punter for the Citadel. North Greenville brings pressure. He'll get a high spinning kick. Fair catch called for by Nigel Gay and received at the 10-yard line with a minute 7 to go. And with 90 yards to go, play calling strategy for North Greenville. They've gone 99 yards or 98 yards on one play. So see if Coach Farrington draws up something that goes after the Citadel defense, or see if they'll just try and take it into the half and think things over in the locker room, and we'll come back out for another half of football. Hunter lines up in the pistol. He'll hand it off to Tracy Scott. As Scott makes some nice moves up the middle and is brought down just shy of the 15 to the 14. North Greenville moves quickly, though. Second down and 5 after the 5-yard pickup. Two receivers right. Hunter still in the pistol. Gets the snap. Another handoff to Scott. Scott with another big hole. Outmaneuvers one linebacker. Now has the first down to the 31. Clock stops while the chains will move. And the Crusaders want their last timeout.
Yeah, they're going to take it right here. That was a good run. Gave them a little more field position.
And now you're at the 31. You start taking shots down the field. You've got Sanders on the outside. He's had two targets tonight. Hasn't been able to come up with them. You also had Javon Smith down the field. He's been strong tonight, as reeled in the two touchdowns for North Greenville so far. As the Bulldogs defense, we talk so much about this offense. Their defense, with their 5 interception, leads the SoCon and is tied for 37 in all of the FCS. They also lead the SoCon in sacks per game, so this defense is no pushover either.
This might be a good time for them to go to Sanders, because Smith will probably be double teamed here if they do decide to go long.
North Greenville taking every bit of this timeout to draw something up from their own 31 with 39.6 seconds left. It will be Tristan Jackson in the backfield beside Hunter, who's in the gun. 4 total receivers in this formation. Hunter gets a snap, drops back. Citadel brings pressure. Hunter lets one rip and misses Javon Smith out on the near side.
Yeah, it was a throwaway. The Bulldogs had great coverage on all the receivers.
Nobody open down the field, throw it away. Back judge wanting the play clock reset. There we go. Four receivers again for Hunter in the gun. 35 seconds to go. Second down, Hunter looks, pass, throws, pass complete. And shoved out of bounds as a late flag comes out. Back where Hunter is lying down on the turf.
Yeah, Brooks on the reception and got out of bounds quickly.
Personal, the passer, 50 of the defense, 10 yards added to him.
A roughing the passer call against the Citadel will tack on some extra yardage to that reception, and that puts the ball into Citadel territory to their 47.
I'm figuring about 12 yards is what they need for the field goal attempt, if they choose to go that way.
Gradley's long is 47, which means they need to get to the 30. 4 receivers again. Hunter gets the snap, drops back, throws, and it will be incomplete, looking for Smith again. And Kalik Williams went up for it, and if maybe he was 8-9 feet tall, that would have been the best interception of the season, but Hunter overshoots everybody, and that will be second down with 27 seconds to go.
And now he's got Sanders on the far side, so Sanders can use that height.
It's a snap here. Citadel brings pressure again, and Hunter's going to go down back at the 45. This is not what North Greenville needed. 15 seconds, and this might be, no, North Greenville's going to line up and try to run another play. Citadel having trouble getting set. Now they do. Hunter gets the snap. They bring pressure again. Hunter twists out to the far side on the run. Hunter lobs one up, and this one will be picked off at the 33. Now on a chance for the return down the far sideline, and there's going to be a pick six.
Yeah, not a good decision by Hunter on that one. Running and trying to throw at the same time, threw it up short.
And a late flag again comes out as D. Delaney ran it in.
The clock is showing zeros. The referees are in a full conference right now.
And nobody's left the sideline, so Well, both the flags are down in the end zone, so more than likely it's going to be after the play. Personal foul against the Citadel. Official's mic not working. It was an unsportsmanlike call against the Citadel. So right now the Citadel leads it by 13. And now hold on a second. That was against the Citadel before the interception.
I think they're going to give North Greenville one more play, even though the clock is at zero.
So I'm still not sure what the penalty was. An official signaled pass interference, then he signaled unsportsmanlike conduct, so. Well, the Citadel will get possession, but there's 0 seconds on the clock, so the Citadel's gonna get a play. They took the touchdown off the board as it's a pitch play to the far side to Renew. He's banged out of bounds after a 5-yard pickup. So reading the scoreboard, North Greenville will take it into the half against the Citadel down 7.
And the Bulldog coach is not going to be happy they took 6 points off the board. He's definitely going to talk to his team about that.
Yeah, that's a tough one to take if you're the Bulldogs. A pick six goes your way, but then a late penalty comes out and takes points off the board. As we are at the half between North Greenville and the Citadel, 21-14. Bulldogs lead at North Greenville. Will receive the second half kickoff. So far, pretty solid game here at Yale Stadium. The Citadel coming up to play on a Thursday night. As here is Ansley with Coach Farrington down on the sideline to get his thoughts here on this first half.
Coach, you've done a good job slowing down the Citadel's triple play option, and you've also done a great job keeping pace with the Bulldogs. What do you need to do in order to keep that up in the second half?
Well, we got to make them work for it. We give up a few big plays, and we're trying to get things corrected, and we were able to score on some big plays. We need to be able to find a little bit more with our running game and put some drives together.
All right, Coach. All right, back to you guys.
311 total yards of offense for the Citadel, all of them on the ground. 297 yards of total offense for North Greenville, 253 of those through the air. So two totally different offenses clashing here tonight. We'll step away for our halftime timeout. Bulldogs up over North Greenville by 7, the ninth team in the country in FCS. And we'll step away here on the North Greenville Sports Network, bring you back just before the second half gets underway.
Ladies and gentlemen, the North Greenville University Administration and Board of Trustees, Paul Lippin. captain Virginia Thomas, Olivia Curry, Nathan Rowe, and Ethan Briggs. The brass captains are Brian Valenzuela, Mira Roberge, Sarah Susan, Corey Merritt, and Jessica McDonald. The percussion captains are Carson Myers and Francesca Scott. The guard captain is Emil Hamburg. The featured player is Miss Rachel Huber. Here's this name, Miss Mangela in Southeast. It is a top five collegiate national finals in 2016. And now a great tie for the first time this season. The Merchant Crusader Band encourages you to sit back and enjoy this year's halftime show. This is designed around the music of Rodgers and Hammerstein's great Meridian musical, The Sound of Music. I'd also like to thank our family, friends, and businesses that have supported us through the years. Thank you once again to the Marching Crusader Band.
Thank you.
5 minutes to go until the second half begins between the Citadel and North Greenville University. Some first half numbers to go over. We have a score of 21-14. We'll tell you how we got there. North Greenville started off the scoring 7-0, a 98-yard touchdown pass from Will Hunter to Javon Smith. Extra point was good. North Greenville led early 7-0. The Citadel answered promptly. Not even 2 minutes later, Reggie Williams ran it in from 17 yards out to tie it up at 7. Then the Bulldogs took their first lead of the game. Rod Johnson ran it with a 49-yard run for a touchdown. That put the Citadel up 14-7. Javon Smith struck again with another touchdown pass from Will Hunter, 90 yards this time. That tied us up at 14. Then, with 5:29 left to go in the first half, Cam Jackson ran it in from 52 yards to make it 21-14. And then right at the end of the first half, the Citadel had a pick six called back because of a personal foul penalty on the return. So those 6 points were taken off the scoreboard. And we sit at 21-14. North Greenville will receive the second half kickoff. Tracy Scott has seen the most action tonight for North Greenville. 9 rushes for 49 yards. Ashton Hurd has gotten to the field, 3 rushes for 29. Simeon Bird was only on the field for 1 rush, no gain. Will Hunter has been sacked twice for a negative yardage of 20 yards. The Citadel, all their offense has been on the ground as we expected. Cam Jackson has 98 yards and a touchdown. Reggie Williams, 69 yards and a touchdown. Rod Johnson, 53 yards and a touchdown. And Dominique Allen, the quarterback, has been using his legs this game, 47 yards. Passing-wise, only 3 attempted passes, none of them completed for Allen. Compare that to Will Hunter, 8 completions on 19 attempts. He did have that one interception that was called back. Will Hunter is having a night against an FCS leading 5 interception Bulldog defense, 253 yards and 2 touchdowns for the sophomore quarterback. Receiving wise, Javon Smith leads all receivers, and he might come down with the biggest total tonight. 3 catches for 210 yards, 2 touchdowns to Marjay Rooks, 2 catches for 18 yards, Tristan Jackson 1-for-9, and Christian Bruce also 1-for-9. Tackling wise, once again, Sam Houston for North Greenville right at the top of the tackling chart. 13 total tackles through the first half, and he is on his way to having a 20-plus tackling game for NGU. Tevin Floyd leads the way, tied at 4 tackles with Ken Allen, 4 tackles each. Floyd also credited with a sack and a tackle for loss. Ken Allen and Jonathan King each have a tackle and a half for a loss. I mentioned the offensive numbers before we went to break. 297 total offense for North Greenville, 314 for the Citadel. 2 of 7 on third downs for North Greenville, 3 of 7 for the Citadel. But the Citadel does have the edge in fourth down categories, 1 fourth down conversion. And that might come up crucial if this game stays as close as it is late into the fourth quarter. 4 total penalties, 2 against NGU, 2 against the Citadel. And that is roughly where we stand. Time of possession. See if I can find that relatively quick through the first half. Citadel leading in that category as they did against Western Carolina, but North Greenville hanging in there. 17 minutes of that first half went to the Citadel, almost 13, 12 minutes and 45 seconds went to NGU. So still a dominating performance by the Citadel on the ground. We expected that. They lead in time of possession, but North Greenville's hanging around in this ballgame.
Yeah, the first period, North Greenville got a lot of scores, a lot of points, but they didn't have the ball very often. It was mostly the Citadel. See if North Greenville could turn this around. Coach Farrington, at the end of the half, gave an update on what he expects his team to do. And we'll see how they can respond now. They were very fortunate at the end of the game to have that 6 points taken off the board.
And they get, North Greenville gets the ball to start the second half, so this drive is going to be very important. You feel like, is this a situation where you absolutely have to get something on the board, or can you live to fight another day if you don't come away with anything on this drive?
Yeah, that's very true.
So the Citadel will kick it off to North Greenville. Again, the Citadel, number 9 in the FCS polls, 4-0 for the first time since 1992 when they won the SoCon and went to the FCS playoffs. Of course, they did that last year. As this kickoff is buried deep into the end zone, Richard Witherspoon will take a knee, and that'll bring it out to the 25.
Gray, I got an update on the women's soccer game. They ended in a tie, 1-1, and the men are now playing. The scoreboard is showing the Crusaders are behind 1-0.
And a special night where multiple sports going on at once. Football over here at Younts, and soccer doubleheader going on at Pepsi Stadium just across the hillside behind the Citadel faithful. So North Greenville back on the field, first down and 10 from their own 25. Hunter back in the pistol. Two receivers right, gets the snap, fakes the handoff, throws right, pass complete again to Javon Smith. Smith can't break free of the tackler, but he drags him for 3 yards for an 11-yard gain, good enough for the first down. We talk about the presence of Mason Sanders and how the Citadel has been keeping a close watch on Sanders, but Javon Smith has gone off tonight for North Greenville. The Citadel is going to have to wrap him up better if they want to come away with the win. As here's the snap to Hunter. He fakes the handoff, and he's going to be sacked again back at the 28-yard line as, again, the pressure breaks free, and Hunter goes down.
Again, that was another coverage sack. Sanders was covered by his defenseman. They had two on that side, but one dropped off, and the other one stayed right with him. There was nothing going on the left side.
Citadel proving why they lead the SoCon in sacks. They had a game-high 8 sacks against Western Carolina. As a handoff to Tracy Scott, and again, the Citadel brings him down for a loss. So North Greenville going the wrong way after an 11-yard pickup, and they'll face a third down and all the way to Spartanburg, a third down and 17. Two receivers left, two right for Hunter, with Jackson in the backfield with him. Hunter checks the sideline again. He's got 5 on the play clock. 3-2, Hunter gets the snap off, a handoff to Jackson straight up the middle. Jackson fights his way to the 30, down to the 31. So he picks up 4, close to 5 yards, but that's gonna be fourth down. So after a promising start, 11-yard pickup on the pass to Javon Smith, North Greenville takes three consecutive plays backwards, and then they're not able to dig themselves out of that hole. The Citadel already with 3 sacks here tonight.
Coach Frankton definitely not happy with that performance.
Bobby Foos, and a flag comes out as the Citadel had everybody but the punt returner, number 2, Schultz, stacked up on the line. That may have caused somebody to flinch. A false start against North Greenville will cost them 5 more. And the way the Citadel has been return, special teams setting up for their returns, they might end up across the midfield. They've looked to bring pressure again against Foos. Good snap to Foos. The Citadel doesn't bring anybody. Foos, a boomer off, forces Schultz back to the 22. Schultz is going to return this. Schultz to the 25, cuts it back up the middle. Flag comes out as Schultz is dropped at the 31. Well, two flags came up, so they're piled up at the 24, and the officials huddle up to get the call. From where the flag was thrown, you'd think it's either a hold or a block in the back. As they block in the back against the Citadel. So the Citadel, they force North Greenville on a three and out after the initial first down pickup. But now deep in their own territory at their own 14. Two receivers right for Allen, under center. Man goes in motion. They hand off to the B-back, and he's got a big hole up the middle, and that is the best run of the night for Tyler Renew. Straight up the middle, and he has a first down for the Citadel to the 39.
Yeah, if Hydro Gay hadn't got to him, he had six written all over that run.
Now two receivers switch to the left side. Allen back under center. Ten on the play clock for Allen. Gets set again. Here's the snap. Hand off to Renew. No, he keeps it, and Sam Houston is there to greet him. And he goes a yard forward to the 40 before Sam Houston throws him back.
Yeah, good defense. He was lucky to get a yard on that one. They had that play. The Crusaders had that play read all the way.
Second down and nine. Bulldogs sending one receiver right, one left. Allen drops under center. Gets the snap. Hand off to the B-back, Renew, and bottled up again. He gets a yard, maybe two, out to the 42. And that's going to set up third down and long for the Bulldogs.
Crusaders calling for the crowd to get in and out. They've been pretty quiet most of the night.
Both crowds getting into it here on third down and seven for the Citadel. Two receivers left, one right. Man goes in motion out to the flat to the far side. Allen tucks and runs, breaks free of one, cuts it back to the middle, and pushes his way to the first down.
What an impressive run. Allen definitely using those strong legs. We knew coming in he had a lot of yardage with those legs. He's going to take over the second half if the Crusaders don't step up here.
He shook off the defensive lineman, number 90, Anthony Blair, like it was nothing. Allen under center, man goes in motion again, handoff to the B-back, straight up the middle, Renew breaking free and gets spun down, but not after he picks up 11 more yards. And now we saw Simeon Bird go out with an injury back in the first half. Ansley has an update on his status.
Guys, I was able to speak to one of the trainers about North Greenville's number 17, Simeon Bird. He did indeed say that it was an ankle injury. That's all they know right now, but he is out of the rest of the game. That's all I have for y'all guys.
And Allen takes this snap, and if it's not broken, don't fix it. Hand off to Renew again, and he again plows forward for 5 yards, and it's second down. But running back core for North Greenville tonight taking some hits. We've seen Ashton Hurd out there, not as much as we've grown accustomed to seeing him on the field, and now Simeon Bird out with an ankle injury. Two receivers here as Allen gets the snap, spins around, hands it off to his A-back, and diving forward, tackled 1 yard shy of the first down goes number 6, Reggie Williams, the A-back out of Palm Bay, Florida, as the Citadel will have third down and one from the NGU 31 and another Crusader down.
With Simeon Bird having an ankle injury now, that's going to put a little more pressure on Ashton Hurd. He may not have wanted to play as much tonight as they're going to have to use him now, but he looks like he's ready to go just whenever they can get the ball and get him back in.
And this is a piece North Greenville can't afford to lose. Sam Houston heading to the sideline, limping a little bit, looking to his left knee. So Sam Houston will take a seat and get further evaluation here, and he's going to be a crucial piece missing here on third down and short.
Weeks is going to have to step up down the defense.
Allen under center, man goes in motion, handoff to Renew, straight up the middle, and he has the first down to the 24-yard line. This is a point in the game where here in the third quarter, the Citadel is going to come out and try and use their conditioning to try and push the way. Really, their rushing offense has been dominating so far this ball game, and they're just going to keep running it at you and running it at you and running it at you. And North Greenville has just had trouble stopping it all night.
Houston is back in the game, Gray.
Back in there at his middle linebacking position. One receiver right, one left. Allen back under center here on first down and 10. Man goes in motion. Toss play to Williams. Gets the block. Breaks free of one. Gets upended as he falls across the 20 to the 19. And he got two of those yards flying through the air down to the 18-yard line. Another big pickup on first down. He gets close to seven that time. They give him six. Second down and 4. One receiver, actually both receivers now to the left side of the line. North Greenville looking to bring pressure. Allen gets the snap, handoff to Renew, straight up the middle. Weeks first to greet him. And again, stopped a yard short of the first down marker. It'll be third down and 1 for the second straight time from the North Greenville 15.
Crusaders now sending in their short yardage defense on the front line.
Watch the edge play again. The Citadel has had that open all night. Reggie Williams, recipient of the toss plays from his A-back spot. Two receivers right, Allen under center. Linebackers move up. Allen changing the play at the line. Five on the play clock. Three on the play clock. He gets a snap off, handoff to Renew. The B-back, no, Allen keeps it straight up the middle and into the end zone. Citadel touchdown. Those fakes are so well executed that all but three members of the defense went to Renew, and Allen almost did. I think he went untouched into the end zone.
Yeah, I didn't see any of the Crusaders get near him. He just walked right in.
Cody Clark back on for the PAT to put Citadel up two touchdowns.
Number 87, Cody Clark, will try the extra point.
Snap is down, low snap, but he gets it up, and it is good, and the Citadel pouring on the pressure. They lead it 28-14, all of their offense coming on the ground.
Well, they managed to get those 6 points back that they lost at the end of the first half. 6:48 to go in the third quarter now. Time for the Crusaders to step up.
Hey, your air attack has had a stellar night. Javon Smith has 221 of your 264 passing yards. Will Hunter's completing a little less than 50% of his passes, but still a good job finding the open man, as a couple of these receivers have been able to break free of the Citadel defense. And now down two scores, you're gonna have to bring some of those quick plays back again to try and fight your way back into this ball game and find a way to at least somewhat slow down the Citadel rushing attack, because they are all over the field at will. And yet somehow they still do not have a tailback over a rusher over 100 yards yet. But Dominique Allen makes that the fourth different Bulldog to find the end zone tonight.
Char with the referees to run the clock down on their clock, and want to give both teams plenty of time to get the right players on the field.
Now I don't know. No television here this time, so no TV timeouts, but the officials taking a little bit extra time. Char Witherspoon back deep at his own two, set to return this. And he's flanked by Damaje Rooks on the left. Citadel, line drive kick, end over end, forces Witherspoon back again deep into his end zone, and he will take a knee and bring it out to the 25.
And the Crusaders will take over, first and 10.
Now important drive, halfway, just past halfway to go in the third quarter. This is a statement drive for North Greenville, down two scores.
Yeah, they have to get at least 3 points on the board if they can't get seven. I know Coach Franklin would rather have the touchdown, but even if they could get the ball down where Bradley can use his legs, he can bring this team back.
Two receivers right, one left. Sanders over there again, lone man matching up to the left side. Tight end drops into the backfield with Hunter and Tracy Scott. Hand off to Scott, up the middle, and Scott will go nowhere. Loses two on the play. And North Greenville's rushing attack is not having a good night. The Citadel is just getting such a great push up front. It is incredible what not only these defensive linemen are able to do, but they're letting a linebacker go free on a blitz sometimes, and they're just stuffing this running attack before it can ever get going. Two receivers right again, one left. Hunter might have to throw it here on second down and 12. Looks down the middle of the field, scrambles out to the far side, gets away from one, is going to try and run for it and get shoved out of bounds. And he loses another yard back to the 21.
Crusaders showing too many yards tonight to get that first down. They've had a lot of plays with long yardage.
And it's not, Will Hunter hasn't been running for his life tonight. He hasn't really had any opportunity to. The Citadel's brought him down three times in the backfield, and they've only allowed 38 yards on the ground from North Greenville, as they have well past tripled the rushing yardage on the ground. Snap to Hunter, handoff to Tristan Jackson, and Hunter's going to fake it. He's going to throw it. Pass complete, trying to get a block is number seven, Damaje Rooks. A flag comes out. And this one's going to be coming back. We do have a SoCon crew in the building tonight. A hold against North Greenville. I think the official's mic has gone kaput. So what would have been a first down, or very close to a first down, will now make it third down and showing 10. So somehow that was still a positive play for North Greenville. Two receivers left, two right. For Hunter now in the gun, Jackson to his left. A motion receiver further out to the left side. Now they bring Rooks in motion across the line to make it unbalanced to the left. Hunter forced to scramble, sets up the screen to Jackson. Jackson with room to run, banged out of bounds. Two yards short of the first down at the 33. And here comes Foose and the kicking unit. It almost worked, but Jackson brought down 2 yards short.
Yeah, just too big of a challenge for the Crusaders on that play. They come 2 yards short. I think Jackson was looking for the stick, but he just couldn't get there.
DeAndre Schultz back at his own 25. Foos on to kick it away. Low snap to Foos, picks it out of the turf and gets another high kick off, forces Schultz back to the 17. Schultz breaks free of one, can't break free of two as he's brought down at the 19. Like number 29, Bryson Jordan brought him down, and now the Citadel up two touchdowns. Can really put the pressure on here if they march down the field and go up three scores. North Greenville's got to find some kind of way to stop the rushing attack. Because what I've seen from them tonight is they'll go up the middle a few times, and then they'll spread you out by doing a toss play out to the far side with Williams. Citadel approaching 400 yards of total offense, and to no surprise, also 400 yards on the ground. Allen back under center with two receivers, one near, one far. They throw to the far side man and pass complete. And going nowhere is the receiver for a minimal gain of maybe a yard. That's the first pass completion tonight for the Citadel.
And they finally got one completed, even though they only got like a yard. Their biggest play for this game seems to be the pitch out to number 6, Reggie Williams. That Palm Bay, Florida player is carrying the ball, usually finding the hole over on either the right or the left side.
As Allen drops back under center here on second down and 9. And lots of movement up front as Allen didn't look ready for the snap. And hold the phone. No flags came out, but Allen bobbled the snap, fell on it, and it cost him a yard. Third down and 10 after the fumble on the snap. Two receivers left for Allen. Only two backs in the backfield as Allen looks to pass, looks to the near side, throws, passes, bobbled but caught. And he's going to be a yard short of the first down as that was complete to one of the A-backs, Rod Johnson, but that's fourth down.
Yeah, Witherspoon right there just caught him by the shoe top just to bring him down. Saved that first down.
Now two pass completions on that drive for the Citadel, but it's not enough and they'll have to kick it away. Good job by North Greenville to force the third down and long and make the Citadel throw it. Fourth and 1 from the 28. Nigel Gay back at his own 34 will have a chance at return. North Greenville rushes 3, but the punt gets off. And Gay calls for it and catches it in traffic at his own 39-yard line.
Very close to the best starting field position the Crusaders have had tonight. A lot better than starting on their 1.
North Greenville tonight has, you mentioned, the drive started from their 1. Most of the time they've been starting from either their 25 or the 20 because the kickoffs have been sailing into the end zone. This will be their best starting field position from their own 39 compared to 3 times from their own 25. The Citadel, in the meantime, their best starting field position tonight has been from their own 46-yard line, so their special teams have been big for them tonight.
Scoreboard is still showing 2:45 to go in the third period. Bulldogs 28, Crusaders 14. Chance here for the Crusaders to make a dent into that deficit. Look for a lot of passing this time.
Ashton Hurd back on the field at tailback. Devon Terman in the backfield as well. Two receivers right, one left for Hunter, who's in the pistol. Officials yet to signal the start of play. And still waiting. And here we go. Hunter calls for the snap. Gets it, fakes the handoff to Hurd, throws, slant route, pass complete to Javon Smith. He can't break free, but he picks up 14 yards into Citadel territory, just barely at the 40. They mark him back to the 48, but a first down.
Yeah, Crusaders are going to have to go more air time here now, try to open up that running game if they can.
One receiver right now, two left. Hunter still in the pistol, calls for it, fakes the handoff to Hurd. Here comes pressure. Hunter throws it, and incomplete, looking down the field to Mason Sanders.
That's a shame. Sanders had two defenders, maybe even three defenders beat on that. If the ball had been just a little shorter, Sanders could have run under it.
That was number 99, Kevin Graham, forcing the high throw. Second down and 10 from the Citadel 48 for NGU. Two receivers right, two left. Hunter's in the pistol, Hurd behind him. Gets a snap. They'll run Hurd right. No, they fake the handoff. Hunter again pressured, throws, and incomplete. Looking for his tight end down the field, Devon Terman. Incomplete. Third down. Hunter had some zip on it. Now here's a flag back in the backfield. North Greenville backing up.
I think Hunter would love to have that one back. Smith had his guy beat, and he was on his way to the end zone, but I don't think Hunter picked him up.
It's a hold against North Greenville, so that goes down. That'll push him back 10 yards from second down and 10 to second down and 20. He only had four total penalties in the first half, and a little bit more laundry being left on the field here in the second half.
Crusaders bringing in their 20-yard play now.
Three receivers right, one left. Hunter still in the pistol. Runs that hard count. Checks the defense, now checks the sideline. Hurd still in at tailback. They got to get Hurd going. Only three rushes for 25 yards. Hunter gets a snap, drops back. Pressure holding. Hunter throws over the middle and in and out of the hands as he had a receiver open and gone. As Christian Bruce couldn't reel it in, it'll be third down.
Yeah, that was a 20-yard play. It was actually about a 30-yard play if he'd have caught that. Just a little too high for him.
Hunter looking a little jumpy back in the pocket since he's been sacked three times throughout this game, and the Citadel not able to get to him so far on this drive, but they've definitely brought the heat. Play clock running down on North Greenville. It's under five, and the Crusaders are going to have to use a timeout. So a timeout called by North Greenville, and you like to try and save your timeouts for the fourth, but play clock running down, you're not left with much of a choice either. Take the delay game, make a third down and 25, or call a timeout and try and draw up another play like that pass attempt to Bruce.
2:20 still to go in the third period now. And 14 points down. Crusaders are going to have to put something together. Might be a good time, like you said, to get the ball to Ashton Hurd, get him around the corner and see what he can do.
Yeah, Citadel's. You can't talk enough about their pressure up front. They've been able to get the Hurd playing tonight. They stuffed out this rushing attack from North Greenville. North Greenville's responded by going through the air as they have over 300 yards of passing offense, but the pressure has been getting to Hunter at the wrong times. And now with 2:20 to go, facing third down and very long. Somebody's time to step up and make a play. Who's going to do it? Two receivers right for Hunter. They'll stack up the line. And Hunter fakes the handoff again. Pressure comes. Hunter forced to scramble. Still scrambling and throws it in the dirt looking for Tristan Jackson. And the thing North Greenville wanted another late hit as it's the second time this drive Kevin Graham got into the quarterback's face, but no penalty forthcoming, and it'll be a punting situation for NGU.
Yeah, that was almost a coverage sack again. All the receivers were definitely one-on-one and covered great.
DeAndre Schultz set to return from his own 15. Foose hasn't had any pressure in his face. The Citadel again stacks the line. And they again bring no pressure. Foose skies one. Schultz calls for the fair catch. Falls on it as a punt returner. That's dangerous. You don't want to do two things, catch it on the run or catch it over your shoulder, also on the run. But Schultz hangs on to it at his own 19. The Citadel will start there. So again, it falls at the feet of the Crusader defense to come up big.
I believe the defense is ready for him now, Gray. They were quickly to get on the field on this ball turnover.
They've been dictating the pace all night. They led in time of possession at the half. Don't think they're going to get to that 43-10 they had against Western Carolina. As men go in motion, a handoff to one of the A-backs straight up the middle, and there goes Williams again, but he stopped after a three-yard pickup to the – actually only 2 yards, so a two-yard pickup will make it second down and 8 yards to go. One receiver left, one right. Allen lines it up under center. One of the A-backs goes in motion. Allen changing things up at the line again. Gets the snap, fakes the handoff, looks to run the option. They option out. Option received, and Williams dropped again, but he gets enough for the first down to the 30-yard line.
Once again, great second effort. That pitch out is their big tool tonight for the Citadel, especially to Williams.
North Greenville set the edge. They did a good job, but it looked like they had too many players watching Allen, and he pitched it out, and Williams made him pay. First and 10 from the Citadel. Mark it back to the 29, still good enough for the first down. Man goes in motion again. Allen hands it off up the middle. There goes McField. McField to midfield to the 40. Dropped at the 30 as McField gets a big one on the North Greenville defense, and the Citadel right back in business.
Bulldogs looking to add on now with a minute 4 to go. Crusaders trying to stop them here to keep a two-score deficit. Looks pretty ominous right now with that kind of a run.
Allen bringing his receivers closer in. Two A-backs and the B-back in the backfield. Man goes in motion, and they toss it out to Williams. Williams finds the edge and gets upended by Richard Witherspoon for no gain on the play. Under the final minute here in the third quarter. They say he lost a yard, so second down and 11. The Citadel... I'm going to have to run one more play before the end of the quarter. Two receivers and three backs. Allen under center, gets the snap, fakes the handoff, looks down the field, is going to air it up. A man wide open in the middle of the field, caught, touchdown. How about that? The Citadel threw a touchdown pass.
Yeah, Williams again, this time just went right straight up the middle. Nobody on his shoulder.
And so the Citadel finally getting some passing yardage. And now looking to go up 35-14. Set up that swinging gate formation. Number 87, Cody Clark, on to kick the PAT.
Number 87, Cody Clark, will put the extra point.
And some movement at the line. Officials again gonna have to come in and offsides against NGU is the call. Penalty is declined and we'll still wait for the kick. Ten seconds to go here in the third quarter. Still waiting on Clark to add the PAT. Low snap. Clark gets it up, though, and it is good. So the Citadel trying to put this one on ice as we have 10 seconds to go here in the third and the fourth quarter to go.
Yeah, don't go anywhere. This fourth quarter could easily turn around, put North Greenville back in the game. Still a lot of football to go here. We appreciate you staying with us on the North Greenville Sports Network for Thursday night football here in Tigerville. We will be with you again tomorrow night for ladies volleyball over at Hayes Gymnasium.
And then on Saturday for another soccer.
It's a soccer doubleheader.
Soccer doubleheader,
yeah. First in the men. And that I believe that's a 1 o'clock start.
I think it is 1 and 3.
Right.
First kick for those.
And we'll be with you live for that event. We're certainly proud to bring you the North Greenville sports, whether it's baseball, football, soccer, volleyball, basketball. You can turn to us for the Greenville sports here at North Greenville University, where we're proud of our Crusaders. We want to bring you the best action that we possibly can.
And North Greenville's, their schedule, this is part, this would be the start of a three-game road trip as they will head up to Greenville, Tennessee next weekend to take on the Tusculum College Pioneers. Mentioned at the start of the broadcast, Citadel will return home to take on UTC, University of Tennessee at Chattanooga. As this one's going to be returnable from the goal line for North Greenville and getting to the 16 and he's finally brought down.
Price is brought down by number 45, Kirk Nixon.
There goes Tristan Jackson on the return, showing off some speed. And that took 4 seconds off the game clock, so one play for Will Hunter to finish off the third quarter.
Once again, it's a beautiful night here in Tigerville. We certainly do pray for those along the coast. Hope that everybody comes through this hurricane situation unscathed.
Two receivers right for Hunter in the pistol. Tailback behind him, tight end to his right. Gets a snap, fakes the handoff, looks over the middle, throws and into the back of Devon Terman, who never turned around to look for the football.
Pass was intended for number 88, Devon Terman.
That'll make it second down on the incompletion. Still 10 to go from the Crusader 16. Hunter checking the sideline, gets everybody set. Two receivers go left, two go right. Hunter with Hurd behind him. Makes the handoff again, throws far side, pass complete, and as the quarter expires, it's Christian Bruce dancing out of bounds for a 4-yard pickup out to the 20. And so North Greenville will have third down and 6 coming up to start the fourth quarter. The Citadel leads North Greenville 35-14. We'll step away for our final timeout and bring you the fourth quarter here as the number 9 ranked Citadel Bulldogs lead North Greenville 35-14 here on the North Greenville Sports Network.
I'd like to once again recognize the sponsors of the North Greenville Athletic Program. Tazoo Custom Wraps, Hampton Inn of Travelers Rest, Nate's Pizza, Pepsi Cola, George Coleman Ford of Travelers Rest, Chick-fil-A of Greer, Tiffany Frail, State Farm Insurance, the Tiara Corporation, Moe Southwest Grill of Greer, Green Tire Automotive, Pat's Cafe of Greer, Sherman Construction, Nike, the Sam Group, and the Inn on Tiger Meadow, one of our newest sponsors here at North Greenville Athletics. If you or your business is interested in becoming a sponsor, or like more information on North Greenville Athletics, please contact Mr. Mike Acepco for more details.
Back here to start the fourth quarter on the North Greenville Sports Network, the Citadel taking on NGU. North Greenville playing up to the FCS level as we get ready for the final quarter, and so far it has been all Citadel in the second half. They look to continue that trend with North Greenville facing a third down and six, as we have had over 800 yards of total offense on the total offense on the field tonight. Plenty of points up on the scoreboard as well. The Citadel leading that category, though, 35-14. Hunter in the gun, takes the snap, looks to pass, throws it. It's batted away, intended for Mason Sanders on the slant, and batted away by number four, D. Delaney. That's his second pass breakup of the night in a critical down situation for North Greenville.
Once again, the Citadel Bulldogs are going to get great field advantage. Probably close to their own 40 is where the receiver is right now.
Their best starting position tonight from their own 46, so they'll look to improve upon that mark. Good snap to Foose. No pressure on him as Foose gets a wobbly kick that will take a Crusader bounce and will be returnable for Schultz as he goes nowhere. He caught it at his 33, got out to his own 37, so a four-yard return before he gets brought down after the four-yard pickup. He thought about it, but North Greenville got down the field in record time on that on the coverage team.
Crusader special team coach Price reiterated to me early before the season started that he was telling his players to stay in their lane on these punts and kickoffs.
Citadel back on the field, looking to go up another score. Allen under center, three backs in the backfield. And now the backup's in the game as it's a pitch out to the one of the A-backs, and he's off to the races. There goes number 31, Rod Johnson, as it looks like Dominique Allen's night is done as Jordan Black has entered the ballgame here for the fourth quarter. Came in for one play back in the first half when Allen's helmet got knocked off, but it looks like this will be his fourth quarter. First and 10 for the Citadel from the North Greenville 40. Black under center, one receiver out right. Gets the snap, and Black's gonna keep it off the left side of the line. Gets to the 36 is where he's called down, so a pickup of four, be second down and six.
I don't think the Bulldogs are losing much on this quarterback change now. He's got legs under him too, and he can run the ball with that extra back.
Again, same formation. Black drops under center here on second down and six. Man goes in motion, a handoff to the B-back, and staying on his feet, getting the first down, goes number 34, Evan McField. Seen some action in the first quarter as Richard Witherspoon slow to get up. Now he does, but another first down for the Citadel. Again, Black under center. Hand off to McField, and he gets spun down after he picks up close to three, down to the 26.
Brought down by number 95, Johnny Birch.
Johnny Birch in there on the stop for second down and eight, so only two on the run. Now two receivers, one left, one right. Black again sends a man in motion. Handoff to the A-back. Up the middle goes Cam Jackson, and he is slammed to the turf. But he gets the first down again. Down to the NGU 17.
The score, if the Bulldogs can get in the end zone, is going to be devastating to the Crusaders. We'll see if they've got the heart to come back.
Black again under center. Man goes in motion and looking around the option play. Options out, but North Greenville stiffs it out. As nowhere to go for Rod Johnson. He picked up one, maybe two. And that's still going to be second down and long. And still, crowd got really excited about something. But I don't see any flags or anything on the field. Now the officials are going to conference about it. Dead ball, unsportsmanlike conduct against the Crusader defense. I didn't see the flag. Now maybe that was a situation where somebody says something right after the play and the officials are... Normally, officials are pretty close to that, and they're going to call it.
Frustration levels on the Crusaders' defense. They're going to have to pull it together here.
Well, the clock stopped at 12:37. And it went to a second down and one, and the officials are going to conference up again. Yep, scratch that. No, it's... It should be first down and goal, and it is. Those always carry an automatic first down. First down and goal to go from the 8. Black under center, two receivers, one left, one right. Only two backs in the backfield. Black fakes the handoff, options out, ball is loose in the backfield, and the Citadel able to recover that one. Rod Johnson falls on it back at the 14, but a bad pitch for the Citadel. Luckily recovered, and so they hang on for another down.
Black showing he can run the ball, but he's still got to learn that option play.
And Jordan Black, the freshman to Dominique Allen at junior. Now three backs in the backfield here on second down and 15 to go to the goal line. Black changing it up at the line, play clock down to 5, 4, 3. He gets the snap off, hands it to his B-back, McField straight up the middle. And McField brought down just shy of the 11 for a 4-yard pickup. And that will bring up third down and goal to go.
One of those passing downs, watch the corners of the end zone. Make sure the Crusaders are on their men.
One, two receivers, one left, one far. Black under center. Gets the snap, fakes the handoff, running out. Nowhere to go, somehow breaking free and brought down back at the 15-yard line. And that will bring up fourth down for the Citadel, and here come the special teams. Good pursuit there by North Greenville. They played the option, forced Black back inside, and he had nowhere to pitch it or pass it.
Crusaders called that one very well. They knew it was going to be the option play. There was receivers down the end zone, but the quarterback had no time.
So the first field goal attempted in this ball game will come from the Citadel's Cody Clark. It is a 32-yard field goal as Clark boots this one up and good. So the Citadel now leads it 38 14, and North Greenville will get it back. 10-16 left to go here in the fourth.
This is the time of game where you've got to have the offense step up now. Might even see some of the reserves playing a little bit. Once again, we appreciate you joining us on the North Greenville Sports Network. It's been a beautiful night tonight. Very little breeze, if any. About 66 degrees, I think, outside. Good crowds. If you get a chance to come to Yount Stadium, we appreciate you coming out. Reminder that we are always on the North Greenville Sports Network for you, and we appreciate you joining us tonight.
On Greenville's offense, getting ready to take the field again, Will Hunter, 13 of 28 for 310 yards and two touchdowns, but North Greenville's been chasing the Citadel's rushing attack, 481 yards on the ground as they put up 513 on the ground against Western last game out for the Bulldogs. That was the most in a game by a Southern Conference team and the second highest rushing single game rushing total in the FCS. And if you add in the 419 against Gardner-Webb that the Citadel had, this one might be another record-breaking performance for the Bulldogs. Godak back on for the kickoff for Char Witherspoon, set for another return. Low line drive kick has plenty of distance, and this one sends Witherspoon out of the back of the end zone for another touchback.
Bulldogs are not going to give Witherspoon a chance to run another one back 100 yards. They're putting everything deep in that end zone on these kickoffs.
So now it's still only a third of the way down here in the fourth quarter. North Greenville offense back on the field. Had a good game through the air, not so good game on the ground. Will Hunter at quarterback, Tracy Scott at tailback. Tight end in the backfield with him. Two receivers left and one right. Hunter fakes the handoff, throws far side, pass complete. And that is Javon Smith again scrambling away from defenders and gets pushed out of bounds at the 31. So a 6-yard pickup will make it second down and four.
Well, Hunter passing has had most of his success to the right, not so much to the left.
Balance formation, two receivers left, two right. Now they bring one in motion to the left side. Hunter hands it off, Tracy Scott. Scott's got a good hole and runs into a defender and bowls him over for 3 extra yards for the first down out to the North Greenville 43. Let's see, the Crusaders still picking up those first downs as that's their 13th of the game. At the Citadel way ahead in that category as well with 27 first downs. Two receivers left again, two right. Hunter lines it up on the pistol here on first and 10 from the 43. He gets the snap. Fakes the handoff to Scott, rolls to his left, throws that way, and heads up on the sideline as he was looking Sanders way, but airmailed that one almost into the first row of bleachers.
Gray, I look for the Crusaders now running back to be tandem between Scott and Jackson. I don't think you're going to see Ashton Hurd in there much with the Simeon Bird sideline. So I think they're just going to go with those two running backs the rest of the game now.
Yeah, with Bird out and Ashton Hurd still, we've seen him in this game, but he's still obviously on the mend. You're going to need him down the stretch in the Tusculum game and especially the North Alabama game. As Hunter gets a snap, Citadel brings everybody after him. And Hunter throws it, trying to set up the screen pass to Scott, but it's incomplete. They'll bring up third down.
It's incomplete. Third and 10 for North Greenville.
North Greenville needs to get to the Citadel 47 to keep the drive alive. Unbalanced to the right side with three receivers, one left. Hunter gets a snap. Citadel rushes four. Hunter steps up, being chased, and stays on his feet, but not going to get the first down as he scrambles across midfield down to the 49. Fourth down and three. And here comes Foose back on to kick it away.
Hunter almost had that first down if they hadn't got him on the shoestring tackle. He definitely had another 4 yards to get the first down.
Schultz back at his own 10 to return another one. Motion to Foose, good snap. And a good kick from Foose is going to go over the head of Schultz and take a bounce sideways, rolls to the two, and right to the one. How about that leg from Foose?
That probably is going to be the highlight of the second half. At least it is so far in the second half. The two touchdown receptions for North Greenville is the highlights for North Greenville in the first half.
And Foose, Bobby Foose did plenty of that in high school out of Chesney, where he also played tight end and listed at those same two positions here for North Greenville. Had a couple of catches last week, I believe it was last week, against Mars Hill, and also got a pretty good leg, as you see there. Downed inside the one, now the Citadel in their own end zone with Black. Under center, one receiver right. Back goes in motion, and Black's going to try and keep it and scrambles out to the three, almost the four, so they get a little bit of breathing room. That's going to bring up second down and eight.
Just under 8 minutes to go in the ballgame now. Bulldogs 38, Crusaders 14.
Now two receivers in this formation, still second down and 8 yards. Back goes in motion. They hand it off to one of the A-backs as that is number 36 back in the ball game. That is Tyler Renew, or 26, excuse me. That is Jonathan DeRogi out of Harmony, Pennsylvania, gets the first down.
Yeah, they gave him the first down. Made it look maybe about a yard.
Get set again. Black under center, two receivers and three tailbacks. One goes in motion. They toss it to the far side and upended after a 2 yard pickup. Goes number 29, Grant Drakeford. And that should be too close to a 3 yard pickup. It'll be, they will officially give him two. It'll be second down and eight. 7 minutes to go. Man goes in motion again. The handoff to the A-back straight up the middle. And another first down for number 26 goes DeRogi again. And the first down for the Citadel out to the 23.
I think the Bulldogs are content to just go ahead and run the clock. They got 99 yards to go. And they're just getting first down after first down, just running the clock down. Now almost down to 6:30.
They need 7 yards to reach 500 rush yards on the night. Black gets a snap, hands off to his B-back, and his B-back fights for yards. That's McField, and McField gets four or six, and it's going to be second down and four. Eddie Studevance on the tackle for North Greenville. Second down and four for the Citadel. Black under center, hands off to the B-back. McField fighting for yardage and gets stopped right after he picks up those four they needed. That'll be a Citadel first down, and the Bulldogs officially over 500 rush yards on the night.
Bulldogs are doing just what they have to do to keep the North Greenville offense on the sideline.
Again, controlling most of this second half. That's been the Bulldogs' pace. Handoff to the B-back McField up the middle. Another 3-yard pickup to the Bulldog 40 or 37. And the clock will continue to roll.
I'd say at this point, Gray, the safeties for the Crusaders can take the night off.
I don't think you're going to be seeing any more passes out of the Citadel offense tonight as McField straight up the middle, outmaneuvers one defender and gets into Crusader territory to the 48. And another Citadel first down. Line it up again, first and 10 from the NGU 49. Two receivers right, three backs in the backfield behind Black. One goes in motion, they hand it off to the B-back McField, straight up the middle. Again, fights across the 45, down to the 44. That is another five, that's a 5-yard pickup. It'll be second down and five.
An update on the men's soccer on the Pepsi Stadium field just over on the other side of the hill. Crusaders are now down 2-0, just entering the second half.
Second down and five for Black and Company. Gets a snap, handoff to McField, up the middle. A few more yards, three, and that'll bring up third down and two. Now in the backfield for the Citadel, of course, you've got Jordan Black at quarterback. You've got Jonathan DeRogi back there, Grant Drakeford, and we've been seeing a heavy dose of Evan McField here on this drive. Black under center here on third down and two. Gets a snap, handoff to the listed linebacker as he's brought down very close to the first down, and he did not get there. That was Jordan Thomas on the carry, and he has stopped on fourth down. Bulldog's going to line up and go for it, it looks like. Fourth down and one. Two receivers right. Black drops under center. Three backs in the backfield. Quarterback keeper by Jordan Black, and he gets enough yardage for the first down, down to the 37.
Approaching 3 minutes to go in the game, 38-14. Looks like the North Greenville stands are starting to empty out now.
Davis, I said I was going to give you a few minutes to think about the trivia question I posed at the end of the, almost at the end of the second quarter, and it's almost been the entire half as here's the pitch to number 26, DeRogi off the right side, and he gets a couple out down to the 35. But the question was, which former ACC coach has coaching ties to the Citadel? Any guess?
You've got me stumped. I have no clue at all.
That's Frank Beamer, formerly of Virginia Tech, was a defensive line coach and the defensive coordinator back in the 70s for the Citadel. So Frank Beamer has coaching ties to the Citadel before he eventually worked his way up to Murray State and then Virginia Tech. As the handoff goes down the middle to the 30-yard line, it'll be third down and short again for the Citadel. Of course, we mentioned all the ties here in this game, even though it's the first time these two teams have ever played. Coach Farrington, a graduate, class of 1982 from the Citadel. Head coach Brent Thompson was the offensive coordinator at Lenoir Rhine when they schooled at North Greenville regularly sees. As here's a handoff to one of the A-backs, Drakeford, off the right side of the line, dives for the first down, and it looks like he got it.
Number 92, Rashad Miller on the stop.
Bulldogs keeping the ball now, keeping the offense on the sideline. That's what they wanted to do, 1:49 to go.
And it has been a prolific night for the ground game for the Bulldogs. Of course, that is their strong suit, and they like to keep it that way. Hand off to Black. He rolls out left, cuts it up the middle on the quarterback keeper, and finally gets shoved down at the 21 as he almost got right back up and kept going, but the clock runs under a minute and a half. Black picks up 6, second down and 4. And looks like the Citadel's going to line it up in the victory formation now with the final minute to go. Black under center with his three backs around him to guard against any sort of slip up here on the snap. Black lets the play clock run down to under 5. We'll snap it and take a knee back at the 21. And one more play should put this ball game away. So the Citadel is going to end up with just about 10 yards shy of 600 yards of total offense for the night. Another knee from Black with 27 seconds to go. Resets the play clock to 40 seconds, and here come both teams to midfield. Coach Farrington, of course, first man out there to greet head coach Brent Thompson. And the Citadel Bulldogs, with under 10 seconds to go, will improve to 5-0 on the season. Stepping out of the SoCon to play North Greenville. North Greenville falls to 3-3. And coming up next for the Citadel, once this hurricane that is running amok along the southeastern seaboard finally gets clear, the Citadel returns home next week to take on Chattanooga. 3 p.m. kickoff for the Bulldogs. North Greenville heads up to Greenville, Tennessee to take on the Tusculum College Pioneers before the big matchup with future Gulf South opponent North Alabama in Florence, Alabama.
It was a good chance for the North Greenville team to realize what it was going to be like when they get to the next level with the Gulf South Conference. They're going to be meeting a lot of teams better than what they've been seeing. Not that they've been that bad of football teams, it's just North Greenville seems to be stronger this year than I've seen in the past. And it was a good contest, well played. Have to give a lot of accolades to the Citadel Bulldogs, their coaching staff and players. Played with a lot of heart. I think they were a little surprised early on in the game and had to reach down and tighten up those shoestrings and bring their game back together. Got a quick surprise by North Greenville right on the get-go here with a two-play 99-yard touchdown early in the game.
It was the Citadel leading only by 7 at the half, but it was all the Citadel in the second half, a 17-0 run to put the final score at 38-14. Our only field goal of the game came in that fourth quarter. Those were the only points on the scoreboard for that quarter. 14 in the Citadel for the third, and North Greenville got on the scoreboard in the first half, shut out here in the second half. So the final numbers as this contest is over. Will Hunter for North Greenville, 14 of 31 passing, 316 through the air. A good night for Hunter against a Division I defense. 2 touchdowns, and both of those to Javon Smith. Tracy Scott saw the bulk of the workload for North Greenville tonight. 12 rushes, 50 yards. Ashton Hurd, 3 rushes for 25. Jackson and Bird each with 1 attempt. Jackson with 5 yards. And unfortunately, Bird, who went out with the injury, ankle injury, Bird and Hunter both end the night with negative yardage. Javon Smith went off tonight. He had those 2 big touchdown plays, 1 for 99, 1 for 90. He finishes the night with 6 receptions for 240 yards, 2 touchdowns, and that long one of 98. Demajay Rooks, 3 for 39 yards. Tristan Jackson, 2 for 17. Christian Bruce, 2 for 13. That one could have been a lot more, had a couple drops tonight. And Pedro Maginot reeled in 1 for 7. For the Bulldogs, the passing category will be pretty quick. Dominique Allen, 3 for 6 for 40 yards and a touchdown. Now here comes the heavy hitters. Cam Jackson did get over 100 yards for the Bulldogs tonight. 6 rushes, 107 yards, 1 touchdown, his longest of 52 tonight. Reggie Williams, 12 for 88 and a score. Evan McField tacked on some late in that second half as McField went 11 for 87 yards. Tyler Renew, the B-back for the most of the night for the Citadel, 21 rushes for 83 yards. Rod Johnson went 4 for 76 yards and a score. Dominique Allen, the starting quarterback tonight, 9 for 73 and a score. Jonathan DeRogi, 3 for 21. Grant Drakeford, 3 for 9. Jordan Thomas, 3 for 9. And Jordan Black, 7 for 6 yards. Receiving wise, Reggie Williams, Rod Johnson, and Josh LeBlanc each end with a catch. Williams had 30 yards through the air, Johnson 9, and LeBlanc with 1. Also of note, Williams caught the lone touchdown pass tonight for the Citadel.
Was a very good game, Gray. Very entertaining. Glad to be back at Yount Stadium again here with you for this broadcast. Final score 38-14 in favor of the Bulldogs. North Greenville saw a very good Citadel team and gave their team a little hope going into the future now, knowing that they can stand up.
And we've got Ansley down on the sideline catching up with the Citadel coach, Brent Thompson.
Coach, obviously the game tonight was supposed to be played at the Citadel, but it was played here due to Hurricane Matthews. What was the reaction from your team like?
Well, you know, we had to get over a little bit. We've been out on the road for so long that we were really welcoming coming home. And, you know, when we found out that we were going to have to play another road game, it was a little bit down. But, you know, I thought they faced adversity, they rallied from it, and they've done a great job. They've done everything I've asked them to do, and I can't complain.
Yes, sir. So it was your first time here in Tigerville. What was your experience like?
Well, I tell you what, I was here as an assistant coach when I was at Lenoir Ryan, but it was a lot of our players' first time here, and this is a great venue. They were very gracious to us. North Greenville University, Presbyterian College, they've all helped us out through this, and I know Furman's going to take care of us tomorrow. So I just want to thank all those schools for you know, recognizing that we need a little bit of help and all their help that they provided.
All right, yes, sir. Congratulations on your win, and we wish the best of luck to Charleston. All right, back to y'all.
Yeah, with Hurricane Matthew postponing and canceling and moving a whole mess of athletic events around and forcing a lot of people from Georgia, Florida, Georgia, South Carolina, even all the way up into North Carolina away from the coast. Certainly wish everybody well and safe travels as everybody tries to get out of the way of this thing.
Yeah, I was actually got from the coach. A lot of these schools chip in and help each other. That's the spirit of the NCAA. Giving them housing and food and some things to do while they're here away from home unexpectedly. We pray for everybody along the coast. We hope that everything turns out all right. I'm pretty sure it will. But we're glad to have them here in Greenville.
And again, if you know of somebody that needs a place to stay through the weekend, North Greenville opening up some housing around campus to try and help out some families and some folks as we wait for this thing to pass. Expected landfall Friday night into Saturday morning, and hopefully everybody can make it through this thing okay. But for tonight, the Citadel comes up to Tigerville. It's the second FCS team to do so, third time overall, and takes down North Greenville by a score of 38-14. Next, our next broadcast will be tomorrow night, women's volleyball in action, and on a Friday night against Truett McConnell College, I believe it is. And Dave, we've got one more order of business to take care of. What did you like overall from this game? And then, of course, who's going to be your player of the game for this matchup?
Allen, with his legs, the way he run the offense, passed when he had to. He wasn't very accurate with his passing, but he knew exactly how to handle the triple option. Became a running back himself, got some good yardage. I really like to watch this kid play.
And I really want to find the time of possession. Yep, there it is. The Citadel controlled the ball for 30 minutes, 56 seconds to North Greenville's 20 minutes, 52 seconds. So not quite close enough to that 43-10 they had against Western, but still, they controlled the ball, dictated the pace, even when they had that rough first half. So Dominique Allen is your player of the game for the Citadel. And again, his numbers one more time, 3 of 6 through the air, 40 yards and a touchdown. On the ground, 9 rushes, 73 yards, and a touchdown, averaging 8.1 on the ground. So for a triple option offense, those are pretty good numbers. The Citadel finishes 1 yard shy of 600 yards of total offense. North Greenville went 372. Most of those came through the air, 316. Will Hunter, again, a good night for him. But the Citadel's ground attack was just too much for North Greenville. Each team finished with one turnover. North Greenville, 6 penalties to the Citadel's 3. Zoe, thank you for tuning in to this a little bit different edition of Crusader football here on the North Greenville Sports Network. As the Citadel and North Greenville both wanted to get this game in, we got it in on Thursday night, and hope everybody stays safe as this hurricane works its way in and out of here, hopefully pretty quickly. So for myself, Gray Sullen, for Dave Parson, for Alan and Will Cahaley producing, Alan Ellis and Kimberly Henry on camera, this has been the North Greenville Sports Network. And also Ryan French on camera.